It's about that time.
We still don't have no visual.
Oh yeah,
you got it. Doom doom doom. Hold up. I need where's my cord? Uh-oh, Rick is going off today. We going ham today.
Might need this.
Listen, we apologize. We had a rough time there. Got trying to get it up. Hey, we ain't gonna spend a whole lot of time. Did I say trying to get it up? That didn't make August 25th, man, the block party. Rick, you wanna say something real quick before we get it started?
Yeah, August 25th, the block party we lit and you hosted by yours truly. Everybody gonna be here in the building, the whole fam. Trash it. Hey, we at Power Money tonight. We lit. Sorry for the delay. But we in full effect.
Hey, Lucy, yeah. It's the Eddie Kane show. Sometimes shit happens.
We only human.
Say it again, little bro.
We only human.
Tonight we have power. Give the address.
2335 Greenberg Road, Northeast. Hey, it's
we lit.
We still lit.
We appreciate my entire family. Eddie Kane show. Patrice Payne. Remix Ring. WLVS Radio. This work. Hey, Shake. Turn it up.
She tell me the man and cross me. I'ma make sure he leaking. Make sure that pussy stop breathing. Gun to his face, how I train him. She said she love me, my dumb ass believe him. Cut him off, ask somebody.
14 time award with Eddie Kane show.
Every day's like payday. Champagne, no birthday. Got it out the mud, had to make a way. Yeah. She smoking stupid, yeah, that KK. Bombay with the lemonade. Like coffee, I fade away.
Hey.
Yeah. Yeah, it still smelled on my worst days. Eating good like a cafe. Table full.
I think
like
I got my own squad right here. Yeah. I think I got a perfect match.
Bossed up, I had to make a way. Had to cut
I'm an alley oop one time.
Same problem.
Hey.
But you slow it up, mix it till it's dark. You a dog, all you do is fuck. Pull up, let it off. I'm a boss, get it like lacrosse. Feel like
we good now, mark, baby.
Guess the word, wrap it up after I test it on my toes.
Team time award with the Eddie Kane show. Whoa.
I'm a boss, get a line across, feel like Randy Moss.
We about to take off.
Pull up, let it off. I'm a boss, get it like lacrosse.
Kayne Show, this is the mixtape. Stars of my cloud now, bro. Put your snow and talk, mix it till it's dark. You a dog, all you do is bark. Pull up, let it up. I'm a boss, get it on the cross. Feel like Randy Moss. Catch the work, wrap it up after I test it on my job. My man, you should see the cloud now, bro. Mix it till it's dark. Logo. You a dog, all you do is bark. Pull up, let it up. From a boss, get it like lacrosse. Feel like Randy Moss. Catch the work, wrap it up after I test it on my toes. Money talk, put your snow in top. Mix it till it's dark. You a dog, all you do is
we don't play no game.
Let it off. I'm a boss, get it like lacrosse. Feel like Randy Moss. Catch the work.
We run this music game, man. Test it on my toes. Radio wide. We are the new squad, man. This is the new Get Fresh crew. Talking about the new, all new Eddie Kayne Show featuring Patrice Perry, and my man, CEO.
Checking in.
Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it?
Eddie Kayne Show! Let's go!
All I see, haters looking at me. Charge you a grip, you looking for free. Secular artists are looking for me. Only rep real, S.I.P. Never sell drugs, I still got a key. Breaking the stigma, what Christian can do. Hustle the system, I'm not talking blue. Many don't get it, it's less than a few. Times of struggle, it's less than a few. Came up the way that they told me I couldn't. Many spoke out, they told me I shouldn't. Haters just mad, they mad at the
world.
Hold up a minute, this ain't a gimmick. This is my style, not even real. Feel like
Lil'
drug laser. No need no luck. Such. Bobby and clubs, talking about Christ, spreading the love, raising a notch. Never been basic, running for my cup, I cannot race it. Vision is clear, no need no LASIK. Real is forever, fifth in the state, I be on stage. Looking like high sway, even the crowds that shout me out. Not even bragging, not about clout. Repping for underdogs, cause we been underdog. Who got a back? None of y'all, Apostle Paul. Whoa, I stand tall, get to the point, I got the ball, I'm off the wall. Praise God.
Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't
people
make it?
People don't even know that's gospel, right?
Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it?
I stop when I gotta be. Setting good examples for my brother and my sister. Cause when we got nothing, we got each other. I got a message, I gotta spread it. He can't be around with me.
It's Big Six, aka Kayne Heavy. And you are now tuned in to the Eddie Kayne Radio Show on WLVS.
When I pray for it to be how it is today, what I'm trying to tell you is never say die. Cause where there's a will, there is a way. So
okay.
You move, and what you say, life like a game, but it ain't for play. I'm on my path, trying not to stray. I'm on this path, trying not to stray. And it be high, but I was built.
You can also get this on our iHeartRadio, Spotify. We everywhere.
Thank God I'm blessed and I'm skilled. And this rap stuff pay the bills. I'm spreading love, I know it's his will. But I felt heat, I know how I feel. It's in the field, told my steel. When it was real, I found my chill. You can find yours, just gotta try. You need some help, look to the sky. Let's get it right before we die. And gotta look that man in the eye. I can be hand in hand with the fire. I'm trying to get wings and fly right through the gate.
Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Born in the world to do big things. Made my mama proud, man. Your son got big dreams. Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it? Why would I stop when you said I couldn't make it?
Hey. Why would I stop it when you say we wouldn't make it, man?
It's lit. First song off the mixtape, y'all. Go get that. All streams. Who is remix? Now yours truly, Remix 3.
Young nigga, dumb nigga, keep it drum, nigga. If a nigga play with me, I'ma smoke him like a blunt, nigga. Not a player, but I fuck a lot. Big pun, nigga. You a baby boy.
Jody, you my son, nigga.
Drinking Douce, I don't fuck with the lean.
Nah.
Gator Clucker 20, got the BM clean. Got the drizzy, drink the bitch under the sea. And my bitch a mermaid, that pussy wet as the sea. Pop me a perk, now I'm high like giraffe ass. Chopping from half gang, got your bitch on the handstand. Called a Uber, then she left. She came home to you with dick on her breath. My bitch ass done, now she want breasts. Dr. Miami, here we come on a jet. Bitch, I'm flyer than a motherfucking eagle. I'm on the beach, nigga, I'm flyer than a seagull. Called up the plug, he threw the pounds off the backboard. Can't fuck with these rappers, they be actors. All my niggas be real-life trappers. Popping rolls in the club, nigga, no capping. Young nigga, dumb nigga, keep the drum, nigga. If a nigga play with me, smoke him like a blunt, nigga. Not a player, but I fuck a lot. Big pun, nigga. You a baby boy. Jody, you my son, nigga.
Jody, you my son, nigga. Like I said, that's by yours truly, man. First song off the mix.
Hey, where can they get that, homes?
On all streams, platforms, man. Apple Music, iTunes, Spotify, everything. I'm on iHeartRadio, too. Hey, we lit though.
Goddamn.
Look at the head on their face. When I hop out,
shout out my nigga Smacky, man. Get well soon. You know he's from my side of town, that good old Northeast.
One time for my little bro Smacky. Cut it out. Let's go.
True to what I say. Plug in the gas from LA. Bussing down pounds in the A. Lot of racks, lot of shots. Good shit got him coming back. Back to back. You wanna get it, shoot your shot. That's for the trap. Don't need no fake in my raps. This shit facts. Fresh off the block with all dubs. Thuggin' with Bree sippin' mug. Load all the guns with the gloves. No, who gon' ride when push come to shove. Niggas got guns just because. My niggas get it in mud. No niggas who rich over drugs. When I hop out with the cake, 50 round drum in the drink. We clear the stage over space.
I'm stuck in my ways. I've been busy getting cake. We clear your street with the drink. Don't give a fuck what you say.
Alright, y'all, we got to stop the battle.
True to what I say.
Gonna start that nigga barbershop on Sheriff Road. It's gonna end that HD whistling my alma mater.
You can meet me by the gate.
It's on August 18th from 12 to 2. Wear a red shirt.
Also, don't forget, man, tomorrow, Clay Turn, 1,000 Black Men with Love, 3 to 6:30, we meet at the McDonald's at 3 p.m., man, we gonna proceed straight on down there to Clay Turn, man, wear all white, not all white, but a white t-shirt, white shirt of props, we don't care, just cut.
Look at the hate on their face, when I hop out with the cake. Drumming the drink. We clear the stage over space.
I'm stuck in my ways. I've been busy getting cake. We clear your street with the drink. Don't give a fuck what you say.
Real niggas, the fake can't relate.
Got a lot of hot interviews going down today.
Plugging the gas from LA. Bussing down pounds
my man, Tay Tarantino from Alaska. He be in a few minutes.
Alaska.
Yeah, Alaska. Hey.
Niggas know how we ride.
One time for Bam 640, he coming through. And also my man DMV Hoods and New. What's going on, soldier? Tay Tarantino is in the building.
Come get it on Hayes. You can meet me by the gate.
Shout out my man. One time for L7 Entertainment. doing for my man Fast Fibonacci in a second. We gonna bang this one real quick. This one by my man Ann Glizzy. Let's get into it.
I got shooters in my
hood. Gonna keep us wrong.
Mixtape.
I got shooters in my hood just for my safety. Got a gun under my hood that ain't got safety. Mama doing drugs now, and I think shit crazy.
What time am I doing day day? We've been all over the world with this shit. Talking about we was with the nigga Real Carter. Rock Nation. I'm the voice, he the cam. We put it in the motherfucking air. Let's go.
Daddy doing drugs, look.
Entertainment, man.
I got shooters in my hood just for my safety. Got a gun under my hood.
This shit just entertainment, man.
Mama doing drugs now, and I think shit crazy. Growing up,
fuck going on.
Little crack, baby. I got shooters in the hood just for my safety. Got a gun under my hood.
Man.
I be with smoking sugar, don't make me let him go.
Let him go.
They'll rob your ass just like Curtis Snow.
Like Curtis Snow.
Money said he in the hood and he's selling blow.
Sellin'
blow. Ask about me in the hood, I'm the next to blow.
Fat
Jefe got the hood like Lord Mexico.
Yeah.
GQ still taxing crackers like
a
Texaco. I'll shot love in the leg just like Plexico.
Just like Plexico.
And swipey last tweet, I might be nothing. Shooters in my hood just for my safety. Got a gun under my hood that ain't got safety. Mama doing drugs now, and I think shit crazy. Growing up in the hood, little crack baby. I got shooters in the hood just for my safety. Got a gun under my hood that ain't got safety. Mama doing drugs now, think that shit crazy. Growing up in the hood, little crack baby.
Hey yo, man, the all new Eddie Kayne Show, man. I know my man probably like, who in all these motherfuckers? Yeah, we got the all new crew, and we can right bring some fire through, man. Hey, before we do that, though, I got to show this cat here some love. Shit, we was down in Houston together, man. Where was we at? Shit, we was in Texas South by Southwest. Shit, man. Hey, listen. We was at South by Southwest doing it heavy, man, with my man Real Carter, man. And this dude right here was on the show with us, man. Talk about my man Fast Fibonacci. He down in Atlanta doing some big shit. Just saw he did something with money, man. Salute, boy. This is an L7 exclusive, man. You heard it first right here on the Eddie Kayne Show. We don't make the record, we break the record.
Jupiter got me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip. Smoking that dope, that arugula. Call up my bro, told him, go get the rulers up. Shooter shit up, this ain't new to us. Answer the phone, I love you, he booted up. He talking like God, the 40 nailed him to the cross. I left his at crucifix. Me and my nigga from Jupiter got me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip. Smoking that dope, that arugula. Call up my bro, told him, go get the rulers up. Shooter shit up, this ain't new to us. Answer the phone, I love you, he booted up. He talking like God, the 40 nailed him to the cross. I left his at crucifix. Shit, I mean crucified.
What he rapping? I just might go get the weapon. Chopper gon' sneeze it, then blast him. Glitz school, I'ma teach him a lesson. Pit move, I finesse and maneuver. Air holes, ain't no drinks in my cooler. Big team got me splitting medulla. Kill tech, nigga, this ain't no Ruger. Had to tell him, nigga, you ain't no shooter. By the way he talking, he could've fooled me. I ain't fixing shit, but I got the dually. He done hit the dip, now he get the drooling. I remember when he nessed a maneuver. Salt and pepper got my man looking stupid. 40 go right through his chest like a cupid. Your nigga do what I say, he a student. Chain wet, got my shit looking loosey. Call him Ricky, nigga, he got the loosey. Call your bitch up, nigga, she got the juicy. I just wanna fuck that bitch in jacuzzi. I just wanna shoot her, nigga, with Uzi. Young and savage, nigga, I don't know boozy. Think he God smacked
his
poofy. Screaming my name, nigga, she thought she knew me.
Let's go!
Me and my nigga from Jupiter got me me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip. Smoking that dope, that arugula. Call up my bro, told him go get the rulers up. Get them shooter shit up, this ain't new to us. Answer the phone, I love you, he beat it up. He talking like God, the 40 nailed him to the cross. I left his at crucifix. Me and my nigga from Jupiter got me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip.
We got the first interview coming up in a few minutes. My man, Tay Tarantino, is in the building. WLVS Radio. Cloud 9 Vodka, this is the mixtape.
Shitties and hundreds, my niggas go monkey.
What you
do? I woke my gorilla up. My brother just called me, said he called a baddie. I had pee my killer. Pop out that next, I ain't waking up. My team worth a mil, we ain't taking cut. Logo roll with some wagonauts. We all know for wagon stuff. Nigga play with the gang, gon' get it. Why you bluff, nigga? You ain't spend a bin in a minute. Keep a Glock, I'ma send it. I'm really independent. Kill a nigga by myself, I don't need no niggas with it. I don't need no witness, but I still chop out them trenches. In the field, we don't sit on no benches. Too many hoes, we don't trip all bitches.
Got me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip. Smoking that dope, that arugula. Call up my bro, told him go get the rulers up. Shooter shit up, this ain't new to us. Answer the phone, I love you, he booted up. He talking like God, the 40 nailed him to the cross. I left his at crucifix. Me and my nigga from Jupiter got me a gun, so I made it with shooter chip.
Hey, yo, man, that's the mixtape, man. We only got a few more minutes, man.
This your man, International T, New Orleans' own supreme clientele. And you know how it go. Dropping nothing but exclusive bangers. Only on the Eddie Kayne Show. Yeah, yeah.
Rich shooter. Damn. What's up, Bino? Gang. Hey. I feel like Ricky Tang. I've been playing with that Tang. Thought he was my man. Had to kill him for them bangs. Had to pull up in that van. Know that Tesla would be spent. Got snake, though I can't. Can't trust them boys again. Had sex with a friend. That bond came to an end. I'm thugging to the end. That Mac clip extend. Too solid, don't bend. G-Wags, we jumping. Check it to the crib and we humping. Me and Bean know what the song. Make these niggas kiss the rain. Cute food, make the Drake go sane. 4-4, now I'm in a deep sleep. She on my dick cause I gave her good deep. Double coke, we don't really play with weed. 100 rounds if you try to play with me. All the hate and the fake keep it away from me. Need a bitch, I'm real loyal, she wait for me. I call her, she pick up that way for me. Call Boog, he pick up that K for me. Catch a bite, shooting niggas, I ain't nothing to me. Nigga try back door me like he never knew me. Fuck 12, we gon' get to work and keep moving. Got inside my room and I kept grooving. I swear when I start, I can't stop shooting. Lost out, bitch, like what you're doing. I feel like Ricky Tang. I've been playing with that Tang. He thought he was my man. Had to kill him for them bangs. Used to pull up in that van. Now that Tesla will be spent. Got snake, though I can't. Can't trust them boys again. Had sex with a friend. That bond came to an end. I'm thugging to the end. That Mac clip extend. Too solid, don't bend. G-Wags, we jumping. Take down, they humping. Man, be no other. Look, I'm chopping down a brick, Jackie Chan. And we got more sticks than the Taliban. Stop down in your hood, turn it to gangland. I got that powder, I'm pitching it underhand. Hard to get fat, nigga, Bruce Bruce. I keep that 40, it's 22. I'm a rich shooter like my brother Q. Play with my brothers, I'ma punish you. What do you need? I got Molly, bricks, and bells of the weed. Back door lock, gotta stay on my feet. And we got more water than a 7C. Low key, I got the bag, Mr. D. These niggas are back door, you cut they green. I see through the fake smiles, I can read. The muck on the mic, gotta let it breathe. I'm ducking 6 and 7 D. I've been playing with that Tang. He thought he was my man. Had to kill him for them bangs. Used to pull up in that van. Now that Tesla will be spent. Got snake, though I can't. Can't trust them boys again. Had sex with a friend. That bond came to an end. I'm thugging to the end. That Mac clip extend. Too solid, don't bend. G-Wags, we jumping. Take it to the crib and we humping. Me and Bean know what the song.
I'm beating this shit. I thought it was in the record. Only on Eddie Kayne Show, man.
It's kind of crazy, right?
That motherfucker
you
could
know
a motherfucker drum
your whole life.
Yeah, I'm trying to figure out what the fuck going on.
And you feel like
my man Tay Tarantino coming up right now.
And then he violates that.
Hey, Tay. Hey. Jacob.
Once you violate that trust,
get him squared away right here.
Never always, coming yep. back, nigga.
Yep.
Forever my enemy.
No, yeah, he's gonna break coming.
Is that what you want?
Is that what you
want? Me on some other shit, come around up in shade.
Right
is that what you want?
Bro.
I try to play cool.
Pull your chair over here, come on through, man.
We used to be it's friends, now we enemies.
Somebody bring his chair over here.
Used to be close like a kin to me.
Bring the chair over
what you
before.
Expect? Me to stay calm. Fuck you, my nigga, you stole from me. You
know break one of the red chairs over. One of the small chairs. That chair right there, can somebody get that chair?
Bring it wherever you at.
The red shit.
Bustin' no shots, I just stole it. Rockin' my baby and loaded. Don't die my
one of the interns is supposed to do that. Hold up, D.
Shit will never be safe. Forever my enemy. I'm locking, I'm loading, y'all faking me, niggas. I never was silent. You're faking, you fraudulent niggas. You stole from me, niggas, so now you my target. Your mom used to call me your son, but now she gon' find out that mercy is hiding. I really did care for that nigga. Learn me a lesson that trust is no option. I hope he just move and just go. Take him a plane and never look back here. It's no moving back here, cause if he excited, it's right on the spot, yeah. That's how we going, my nigga. DC is hot as my nigga. Rockin' my nigga. Talkin' to all of my niggas. That's how we ridin', my nigga. Switchin' the side on the nigga. Get you up out of here, nigga. You violated, nigga. Creep all the money you stole. Out for your soul. Dilly the pop me, a nigga. Pop me, a nigga. Rest in peace in your grave. Now you with family. Restin' with maggots.
My man D,
I wish I was dreamin'. Wish
you would never hit close.
But this is reality. Is that what you want? Me on some other shit. Come around up and shit. Is that what you want? I try to play cool, but business ain't working with spinning me. We used to be friends, now we enemies. We used to be close like a kin to me. What you expect? Me to stay calm. Fuck you, my nigga, you stole from me. You know who I am. Why would you test me? Have me out here going crazy. You know I'ma find where you at. Bring it wherever you at. Coming and loaded. Bossing no shells, I done stolen. Rockin' my baby and loaded. Don't blind my loyalty. Put some speck on my name. Shit will never be safe. Forever my enemy. The nigga didn't listen, I gave him a chance to get the fuck out here.
Alright.
The work just got back, he's still around, so he gonna die here. He tryna reach out, he calling my phone, but I do no squad shit. You play with me, nigga, look in the face of a nigga. Nigga, I'm hurt, my pressure is out, pulling, I'm about to explode.
Letting it go,
my demons is out, better send kids in the house, I'm bringing them out. I'm Rambo, my nigga. Better bring ammo, my nigga. Handle a nigga. Before I run out on niggas, I don't be playing with niggas. I'm no joke. I got 40s and 45 helmets and 38 dog with the beans on it. I'm sitting behind a tent, riding the
my
nigga.
My man Jacob, I appreciate you, baby. We making some hell adjustments right here on the spot.
Once it is done, I gotta go handle it. The streets is watching, my nigga. Your name is everything, nigga. I am no joke. Is that what you want? Me on some other shit, come around up and shit. Is that what you want? I try to play cool, but business ain't working with spinning me. We used to be friends, now we enemies. Used to be close like a kin to me.
What you expect? People see you, hey baby.
Fuck you, my nigga, you stole from me. You know who I am. Why would
much
you
love
test me?
To
have me out here going crazy. You know I'ma find where you at. Bring it wherever you at. Coming and loaded. Bossing no shells, I done stolen. Rockin' my baby and loaded. Don't blind my loyalty. Put some speck on my name. Shit will never be safe. Forever my enemy.
Hey yo, 14-time award-winning Eddie Kayne show. Good look, baby. You see who we got in the building with us, man.
Damn.
Hey, I gotta show some love. Hey, can one of those brothers help this sister bring that box in, man? She was trying to bring some stuff in the door for tomorrow's 1,000 Black Men with Love. I appreciate you, babe. There you go. Thank you so much. What's the name of the catering company again? K&A Catering. Thank you so much for the donation, and I will put this on social media. K&A Catering, we thank you. 1,000 Black Men with Love will be converging on Clay Terrace tomorrow. Showing love to the community, man. While we want to show love to Makaya Wilson, we are not under any circumstances accepting any donations on that family's behalf. The only thing we're accepting donations for is the Ice Cream Social, okay? The Ice Cream Social from the 1,000 Black Men with Love is about giving to the kids and the elderly because, as you know, Makaya was murdered going to the ice cream truck. So we want to give
Thank you so much, Kayne. We want to get back to the community just for one day, for 3.5 hours, man. We're going to bring a DJ out there, and we coming down there with love, man. We don't want no problems. We just coming with love, man. So I thank Kayne Catering again for bringing. There you go. I appreciate you. I really want to say we come with no malice, so don't bring no malice. Everybody wear a white shirt, man. That's for peace. Hey, right now, man. Got to show a lot of love. What's happening? Hey. Give me a second. All right. What's happening with you? DMV Hoods and News in the building, man. Look, he all wet, man. Have a take your jacket off, man. You look like you soaked, man. We going to get you up right after this interview, bro. Hey, right now, man, all the way from Alaska. Hey, Jacob, can we get a close-up of his... cover somehow. Can we do a close up with that cover? Want to show love to that cover real quick. Tay Tarantino.
Yeah.
You good? They got you.
Yeah.
D, you got a mic over there? Nah, you good? Give him a mic too, bro.
Yeah,
he's over there. You.
Mic. Give my man a mic, man.
Give my man a mic. All right. Thank you. Appreciate y'all. Hey, once again, my man Tay Tarantino. Also, yeah. My man. D. Brodus, a.k.a. man, carries so many different names, man, but the man is a legend with what he doing, man. L7 Entertainment's own, man. Hey, I call him Dame Dash. I call him Dame Dash. Hey, Chachi, what's up, baby?
Man, holding it down, Biggie. You already know what EK, man, doing what we do, baby.
Hey, that's the man behind the camera. So listen, you can take my echo off. How you doing today, brother? Welcome here from Alaska.
Yeah.
You here visiting. How is it different being... Hold up.
You from Alaska, bro?
Yeah, from Alaska, all the way from Alaska.
You got Anchorage, Alaska, nigga, all the way in D.C.?
Yeah, man. Anchorage, Alaska. Yeah, for real, that way.
Hey, so tell us, what is the hip-hop climate like in Anchorage right now? Like, because people wouldn't believe that in Anchorage, Alaska, that people are actually doing hip-hop music.
Yeah, I mean, first, they don't even believe there's black people. Like, you feel me? You know what I'm talking about?
Eskimos.
Let's just keep it a butt. But the music scene, man, is very vibrant, man. It's very popping, full of energy. It's a lot of talent, man, raw talent. You know what I mean? We just up north. So we don't get hurt, you feel me? Way up north, far up north, you know what I mean? So I was just talking about that with somebody today. I don't think our mission is to like sound like anybody else or come on the scene and get any cosigns right off the bat. We just want to be heard and show y'all what we got for real, because we don't even have a lane, you know what I mean? Everybody got a lane. Even Canada got a lane because of Drake, you know what I mean? So we just trying to do that, man, and showcase that and put on... You know what I mean? The best representation of what we sound like, you know?
Man, when people think of Alaska, the first thing they think of is cold. They think of ice and all that. What?
Eskimos.
Tell me, that's the whole misconception. Because when I saw some
dogs.
Video. Huh? When I saw, sled dogs. Say that again.
Sled dogs.
Yeah, and I got bust out by the brother because he did a video out the sunroof with a short sleeve t-shirt on. And it looked like it was spring, summer day.
Yeah, I mean, right now, I just called back one of my people's, they have 80-degree weather out there, 75-degree weather. You know what I'm saying? It's summertime. We had one of the most beautiful summers you ever see and you experience. You know what I mean? You just got to go out there and get a chance when you get a chance. What they showcase online and on TV about us, man, ain't always true. You know what I mean? You do have the winter. You know what I'm saying? It is rough. You know what I mean? You got to be mentally strong to bounce through them winters, but everything else, man, it's normal. We got a McDonald's out there, a mall. We have a summer, spring, winter, fall, all that. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was getting ready to say, you got a swag with you that doesn't resemble or wouldn't give you the inclination that Alaska don't swag out there.
I mean,
because you look like somebody from the city, even though you got city influence.
Yeah,
I would have thought you would at least been dressed skateboard style.
Nah, we ain't doing
you
that.
You
came in here. I would have never known you was from Alaska.
Okay, I own swag. We definitely got our own swag, our own drip, sauce, all that. You know what I mean? We got people out there, you know what I'm saying, that represent their swag and how they want to do what they do. And it's normal people out there, you know what I mean? That's my thing. And coming from where I'm from, how I do, I mean, I've been coming out here since I was 5. So when I was rooted out here, my dad's from here. He from Southeast. So when people hear me talk or they hear me, my little slang or twang and this and that, I got family all over. So I've been traveling since I was 5, you know what I mean? So shout out all my people, Southeast, D.C., you know what I'm saying, Maryland, Oxon Hill, VG, all that, you know what I mean? Yeah. All
right, so what's some of the main inspirations for your lyrics that you write? You travel a lot.
Well, the main inspiration is just telling where I'm from, you know what I mean? Like, where I'm from, that's my inspiration. The things that's going on around me, the things that I see in my city, you know what I mean? I like to tell that because, like I said, don't nobody know where we from. They don't know we got murders. They don't know we, you know what I mean? It's drugs in the community. It's, you know what I mean? It's everything. It's trapping. It's all that out there. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know what I mean? So we just trying to shed light on everything and let people know we got real issues. We got things going on in the community. We got things going on in our city just like everywhere else. So,
you know, that's everywhere, like in every city. But, you know, if you don't educate people, people that's ignorant, you know, they a lot of people that don't know Washington, D.C., they think, oh, it's just the White House, Capitol, the monument.
Right.
Don't nothing go down, but it goes down.
For
too,
sure.
You know what
for
I'm saying?
For sure.
So.
Yeah, that's our mission with that, man, is to, you know what I mean, when I go in and I'm hearing, you know what I'm saying, different artists from they cities and from New York and from Atlanta, you hear from L.A., you hear from all over, you know what I mean? When you represent Alaska, just give them that different feel. Because, you know, when you say it, it's just like, damn, like I said, I don't know nobody. So then when they hear the music and the music follows up and it's good and it's up there with everywhere else.
Yeah,
because like
that's
that.
What I was going to say. We banged you on FM and then turn around, you know, they're going to get a chance to hear the music today. But it's far-fetched from what you might think from an Alaska artist.
Yeah.
What, as she said, what is your inspiration? Like, who do you... When you take your hip hop, because you everybody takes a piece of something from every artist.
Word.
Which artists are more popular, would I say, in Alaska?
I mean, you got different sides, so we got different, you know what I mean, people that listen to different things. Well, me personally, you know what I mean, I slap everything. Like, when I say everything, like, I listen to country music, bro. Like, for real, to be 100. You
I
know
do
what
too.
I mean? Real life. But, I like J. Cole, you know what I mean? That was one of my biggest inspirations coming up. He was like, to me, like our Pac, our Biggie of our generation, like someone that I grew up and became a man listening to him, you know what I mean? So him, let me see, Drake, you know what I mean? I listen to, I like Thug, you know what I mean? People don't, you know what I'm saying? They without all the stuff that goes around with him, his music.
You talking about sex?
And now he's Fifty. Now his music is hard. You know what I mean? How he create Future. Different artists like that. You know what I'm saying? Like I definitely get a lot of inspiration from R&B too. Old school. I was raised on that. My father, he, you know what I mean, Frankie Beverly and Maze. You know what I'm saying? The OJs, stuff like that. So
hey,
definitely
you talking. Hey, look, when you get to talking that. You talking a foreign language to these young boys, but like, shit.
Yeah.
With my generation and the other, we grew up off that. Well, you had to listen to what moms was listening to in the car. You know, dad was listening in the car.
I feel that.
So don't touch my radio.
Talk about the project as a whole.
Yeah, project. New project out right now, man. To Live and Die in AK. I originally dropped a song and a remix to Tupac's joint. You know what I mean? And our mission was to that because we had record high homicides in the city the last 2 years. So with our project, we didn't want people to just get it all right off the bat. You know what I'm saying? We definitely gave them a song first and then we wanted them to just sit on that. But follow up with a whole project. This was a whole scheme. So 14 songs, mix and master by Raw Beats, L Nick's Mastering. Shout out L Nick's Mastering in Memphis. They mastered for Gotti, 3-6 Mafia, Young Dolph, Key Glock, all of them. Shout out to my team, Bad Agenda. But yeah, To Live and Down AK, pre-orders out right now. You can pre-order on iTunes. You get 3 songs with it. It drops August 11th officially on the iTunes, Spotify, everywhere. And yeah, man, the album is on the way. You know what I mean? I think my city personally has been waiting on something from me. We said it. We gave them a little 6-song mixtape with a whole bunch of videos, man. 6 songs, 6 videos all together. It was packaged real nice. And then we smacked them with this, you know what I mean? So I don't even know if they was expecting it, but they were expecting it, if you know what I mean? They wanted it, you know what I'm saying? So Yeah, it's out August 11th. I'm excited about it. I'm doing my press run with now, starting with y'all. You know what I mean? So shout out to Eddie Kayne Show, WLVS, Listen Vision. Yeah. Yeah, man. So we just gonna go home and swiping with this one, man. Everything, you know what I mean? Just give it to them raw and uncut. Like I said, 14 songs that give you something you can relate to, you know?
Hey, yo. Y'all go ahead.
So as an artist, besides traveling from Alaska, of course, what does life look like for you?
Oh, man. I mean, I'm a father, first and foremost, before anything, before y'all see me get on the stage, before y'all do any of that. I'm a father, so I'm definitely with my son a lot. I'm a barber, too. I cut hair. You know what I mean? That's the back end. You know what I mean? People don't understand, like, that what he do, how he be moving. Man, barbering has got me in a lot of positions that a lot of people wouldn't be in. I got the opportunity to cut J. Cole's hair. So talking about him and thinking that's my idol, 2 years later, I'm meeting him, you know what I mean? Cutting his hair on Forest Hill Drive Tour, you know what I mean? Out here, you know what I mean? That's why being out here and being here is like home too, because it's like I do things that people wouldn't do coming from where I'm from. It's people out here grind every day, you know what I mean, to be in certain positions.
Well, you want to know what? I think that you being from Alaska, crazy as it may sound, yeah, you can go platinum in Alaska by yourself because you got your own lane. You say you don't have a lane. You do, because there is no real circuit out there. They need a circuit out there. They on an island by themselves. If they was to be able to create that circuit, man, you could be able to dominate that music. So it's just putting that circuit together, man. You can do that. Your music is on the next level, and I'm sure there's other artists under you.
For sure.
Or nowadays, artists in your city that's rocking like you.
Definitely.
It's just going to take for someone to see you guys.
Exactly. That's what we focus on, the eyes, people to see us.
It can't skip past you and go to Japan and China. They're going to discover you because they're starting to discover DC artists. DC artists are really starting to now get a plethora of looks, you know, and once the door was kicked open, a lot of people walked through. What y'all got to say?
I mean, I see it in him, man. Like real live, like, I never met nobody from Alaska. Like, you was the first person, you know what I'm saying? And I like your whole aura, period.
Yeah,
like,
he very
I
humble.
Believe in you, bro. Like,
that's love, bro, for real, for real. Coming from where I'm from, that's love, bro. It's a lot of hate, you feel me? I'm sure it's a lot of hate in the city as far as here, too. But it costs nothing to show love, you feel me? So that's love right there. I appreciate
that. Not a dime, man.
I really appreciate, you know, how you amplify the fact that you do have, you know, another grind other than, you know, being an artist. I'm pretty sure that that's your heart and soul as well as your son. But, you know, cutting hair, sometimes, you know, a lot of guys or females, artists, period, think that, you know, just because you have a dream or you have, you know, artistry that you don't have to do anything else. But in the real world, you know, you got bills, you know, so you don't try to put on like, you know, I'm an artist or, you know, I'm just trapping. It is what it is. I'm living how I live. You know, you live an everyday life as well.
That's definitely for sure. My mother and my father, they keep me humble as can be. You know what I mean? My dad let me know every day, like, yo, you regular, but you're not regular. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? If I could put it in a way, like, he just tell me to keep focused and want me to provide for my son the best way I can. You feel me? Mm-hmm. And give him everything I got and then more. You know what I'm saying? So we focus over here, man. That's all.
So I just shot you a follow on Instagram, man. Tell everybody out there where they can follow you at on social media.
Man, you can follow me at Tay Tarantino, T-A-Y-Y. That's two Y's on there. Tarantino, T-A-R-A-N-T-I-N-O. Everything. That's everything for the Snapchat, for the Instagram, TayTarantino.com. We got the whole thing. Bad Agenda. Make sure y'all follow Bad Agenda on Instagram. That's my home team. You dig? So follow them. Shout out Voss, Raw Beats, Raw Beats Productions, Raw Beats 907 on Instagram. That's my engineer, my producer. Shout out Big Dog Raw. We stay cooking with him. You know what I mean? Voss, y'all can follow my man Voss. Yeah, man. 49th Supply. I gotta shout out 49th Supply. That's my team too. Branding with clothing. So we got a clothing brand out the city too that's pushing us. You know what I mean? It's sold in Zoomies and different things like that. It is a skateboardish brand, but we got the urban side too coming with me as far as like I be putting it on in the videos, everything. With the video he talking about, he seen me hanging out the roof. I got a 49th Supply shirt on. So they rocking with me heavy from the jump and they support crazy. So yeah, shout out everybody.
Bro, let me ask you just one question. How long does it take to get here? Damn.
Man. depending on what airline you book and how expensive the ticket is. But you know, two flights, you know what I mean, here to Seattle. I mean, Anchorage to Seattle, Seattle to D.C., you feel okay. me? That's the main way I normally fly, you know what I'm saying?
Okay.
It's like 3 hours to Seattle and then another 4.5 to here.
Is it a part in Alaska that it don't get dark at? I'm just curious.
Yeah, in the summertime, right now. It's like 24 it just, hours light. I don't know the exact day. Don't get me woofing, but I know it's a day where we start losing daylight. So then in the wintertime, it be majority dark.
Yeah, that's right.
Damn.
Oh yeah, see, I heard that, but you know, you from Alaska, so I can ask.
He's giving you first hand.
Nah, yeah, that's for real, right now.
So
like,
so just 24 hours light, don't ever get dark.
Yeah, it might get like barely, like the sun might go down where it go down, and then it's right back up. Like you feel me? You'll see the sunset, you'll see it come right back up. Type
crazy,
you know what I mean? Like for real.
That is
putting
crazy.
Blinds up to go to sleep, Joe. Like people be doing that because sometimes the light be bothering them. You know what I mean? But me, I grew up in it. I ain't tripping.
Yeah. Hey man, we got some records for you to rock today. Before we do that, hey Chachi, how you get involved with Alaska artists?
Hey
man. Well, like you know, Tay was saying, he got roots all throughout the South Side, man. And I'm also a barber, a master barber. So we actually went to school together for the craft of barbering. And at that time, man, we both, you know, had a passion for the music. So you know, he went in his direction, I went in my direction. We just stayed in touch. You know, he went from here to Alaska because he was like, man, you know what? I'm going to just go out there and I'm going to take over. And that's exactly what he did. He went out that joint, took over.
Stop.
I was down this joint, you know, like I said, rocking out with you. Like I said, man, we hitting the, you know, we on travel doing the Rail Carter tour. You know, we doing it, the EK, the L7 thing. And
still.
And we, you know, now, like I said, I'm managing Fast Fibonacci, you know what I mean? And
no question, man.
He's doing unbelievable things. We got a whole slew of things coming up the pipeline for everybody. So Tay being my man, Eddie being my brother, you know, I thought it was only right that we come down this jump together, man. Chop it up. You do.
Yeah. I'm going to say something about Chachi real quick. This one of the few people, like, you know what I'm saying? I always tell them, like, bruh, you know what I mean? You meet somebody, they tell you your goals, your visions, your dream, what they trying to do. I seen them really do that, you know what I mean? And that's why we cling together, you feel me? Like, I'm in there telling them, like, I'm coming out here from Alaska, I'm in a barber school, people I don't know, everything, whatever. To put myself out there, you know what I mean? That take a lot. Some people be scared. I'm not scared, feel me?
And for the record, that's the kind of people that you want to hang around.
Exactly.
In general, period. People that got the same visions and goals as you. Like, just to get stuff done.
Exactly. He put that on me, man. Positive energy, positive thoughts. When
hey,
people
man,
say that,
I gotta
that's
say
him.
This. You know when you destined for greatness and you got a great friendship, when y'all can fight like brothers and come right back to it. That was me and Chachi, man. Fight like brothers and we right back to it, man. So you know the love is real, on like he say.
Yeah.
One thing he keep on you, he'll stay on your ass about is positive energy.
Positive thoughts.
Man, if you say anything negative, man, he gonna gate your ass, man. Real live. Hey, you ready to rock the stage?
Yeah, man, we ready to rock for sure. We ready
Tell
to
the
rock.
People where they can find you at, big
hey,
dog.
Man, TayTarantino.com, TayTarantino on Instagram, all that good stuff. Bad agenda, follow the movement, man. We all we got. Y'all know what it is, man.
That's what I'm talking about. Hey, team, y'all got something to say in closing?
Man, I'm just happy that you was here.
I can't wait to hear the music.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh yeah, we finna turn up. We got two joints for y'all off this album, man. That's bananas. One of them been a big record for a long time. My father, he be like, it's just cause he a old head. He ain't really hip to the lingo, but the song go.
One time for your father too.
One time for my pops, man. OG, yeah.
Hey, I gotta say though, this album is, man, extremely special. You know what I'm talking about? I feel like I got a good ear for music. That's why I gravitate to like exceptional artists. Like when I say this joint is a joint like to stand behind, like if you listen to this joint, you're gonna be like, oh man, yeah, all right, yeah, those platinum joints.
He got some good music. His music is exceptional. I give it to him, man. It's next level shit, man. And we're looking forward to see you rock right now, man. From Alaska all the way to DC.
Yeah.
What you gotta say, Rick?
It's lit.
That's his favorite words. My man Tay Tarantino. Hey, boom. I never did get my country.
Yeah.
Hey.
Tay Tarantino right here, man. WLVS Radio, listenvisionlive.com, which will be going on go.
Yeah, we could do Blaze Up first. Hit me with the Blaze Up.
Let's rock.
Yeah, shout out all my folks back in the town. Y'all know what it is, man. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Raw Beats, Bad Agenda. Y'all know what it is, man. Yeah. Huh. Pull up dripping sauce, spill, I'm a boss. Let them know, we above the law. We don't fuck with law, pay the cost. Haters shake them off, sit back, watch me ball. Roll me off, but we beat the odds. Homie, you a fraud, club pack, and we Uber lit. Shooting movie shit, with my clique, fucking up the VIP. Valley never switch, let them know. Where I go, and they train to go. By the code, nigga, we was shows. Nigga, we was show, yeah. Look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems tonight, no haters. Let's blaze up, hey, hey. Look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems tonight, no haters, yeah. Let's blaze up, yeah. Split the wood, roll the doughty up. Call the Brody up, he gon' slide, we gon' light it up. Told me fired up, hella big, double cup to sip. Creepin' in the whip, down the block, heavy with the chop. Ready for a knock, we was broke, now we got a lot. Never would've thought, had a dream, now we at the top. Money never stopped, level up, homie switching up. Never gave a fuck, lost the trust, run them numbers up. Stacking, hush them up, bad bitch, shawty hella thick. Throw it, watch her flip, see the shit, bust it for the ring. Round up every scene, keep it G, let them roll my weed. She was meant for me, instantly, rare sight to see. Shawty meant for me, yeah. Look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems tonight, no haters. Hey, let's blaze up, hey, hey. Look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems tonight, no haters. Let's blaze up, look. I leave the club, still got hella juice. Find another move, south side, hit the food truck. We gon' rendezvous, hella turn, that's what liquor do. Plus we burn a few, out my mind, losing track of time. Hopping on the grind, on the go, wish I could recline. Blaze ease my mind, stressed out, mama will be fine. Watch your baby shine, let me know, if they next up. We gon' skip the line, we them guys, please don't be surprised. City on the rise, victimized, but we improvise. Look me in the eye, fate with hella drive. This ain't televised. Over time, Lord been showing signs. I'ma get what's mine. Over time, Lord been showing signs. I'ma get what's mine. Yeah, look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems tonight, no haters. Let's blaze up. Hey, look, tell them if they light us high, let's blaze up. We gon' blow the smoke in the sky, let's blaze up. Ain't gon' be no problems and ain't no haters. Let's blaze up. Yeah, shout out all my peoples, man. The Living Dying AK on the way. Let's turn this thing up, though. Yeah.
Hey, tell the people one more time where they be to find that at, brother.
And they can find me and get this joint to Live and Dine AK. Pre-order the album right now. You can go get it officially August 11th, you did.
Hey, let's get into it right here. WLVS Radio, the Eddie Kayne Show, man. Patrice Perry, Remix Week. This is Tay Tarantino all the way from Alaska, baby.
I just need y'all to say go when I say this shit. You hear me? Yeah. Look. Huh? Green light, I'm on go. Bad bitch, she on go. Roll up, sip a foe. Got guap, but want more. Got guap, but want more. Haters, they don't want smoke. Two tree, we cut throat. Suge Knight, I'm death row. Green light, I'm on go. Bad bitch, she on go. Roll up, sip a foe. Yeah, got guap, but want more. Yeah, got guap, but want more. Yeah, haters, they don't want smoke. Yeah, two tree, we cut throat. Huh? Suge Knight on death row. Look, green light, I'm on go. Huh? Bad agenda on go.
hustle all that we know. Run it up and get more. I bust it open, get low. Show me what you here for. I drill the pussy, said I kill the pussy. So it's murder all that she wrote. Team strong and we heavy. On call and they ready. Let a fuck nigga test me. Shoot a snipe like Wesley. New shit don't impress me. Your new jewels and investment. Tough guy, quit the flexing. You don't really want the pressure. Kill the beat, need a stretching. Teaching on them, hit a lecture. Your main bitch wanna sex me. Heard a friend wanna neck me. Girl, I'm willing if you ready. Yeah, know I might sound petty, huh? Niggas soft like Teddy's, huh? Both niggas count pennies, huh? Two up and we lit. Break the wood and Rosell's. Chef Curry with the wrist. Double up and make a flip. Bet this money make a flip, huh? She gon' fuck for a trip. She gon' fuck for a trip. I got the bang head with no tip. Woo! Green light, I'm on go. Bad bitch, she on go. Roll up, sip a foe. Got guap, but want more. Yeah, got guap, but want more. Yeah, haters down, won't smoke. Huh? Two trees, we cut throat. Yeah, Suge Knight, I'm that road. Green light, I'm on go. Yeah, bad bitch, she on go. Huh? Roll up, sip a foe. Yeah, got guap, but want more. Yeah, got guap, but want more. Yeah, haters down, won't smoke. Huh? Two trees, we cut throat. Yeah, Suge Knight, I'm death row. Look, been a winner, that's a fact. No, I never been a rat. If I don't know, you got a tax. Overtime to get it back. Blow the money, get it back. Yeah, being broke ain't going back. Yeah, need an Oscar, he can act. Mix the Fanta with the act. Yeah, youngin' got it out the mud. Ghetto boy from the slums. Yeah, used to pray, he see the funds. Gotta risk it for my son. Yeah, people saying I'm the one. Knew I always been the one. Yeah, pack and swole, big pun. Big tree from the jump. Yeah, made a vow, never quit. Had my time too legit. Better pray my shooter miss. Sit the Henny, blow the piff. Mama knew I had a gift. I told her she ain't got a trip. Yeah, hit the line and get a whip. Tell them hey to get a grip. One time, green light, I'm on go. Bad bitch, she on go. Roll up, sip a foe. Got guap, but won't more. Yeah, got guap, but won't more. Haters down, won't smoke. Yeah, two trees with cut throat. Suge Knight, I'm death row. Green light, I'm on go. Bad bitch, she on go. Roll up, sip a foe. Got guap, but won't more. Got guap, but won't more. Haters down, won't smoke. Two tree we cut throat. Suge Knight, I'm death row. Shout out WLVS, man. Listen, Vision. Eddie Kayne Show. Appreciate y'all rocking with me.
Yeah. Hey, yo, man. That's that boy, Tay Tarantino, man. All the way from Alaska. Right now, man, we got another guy in the building, man. I got to show him some love, man. This dude right here, man. Uh-oh.
It got more sounds than that, too, Reek, man. It got more sounds than that. Fire truck, all that shit, man.
Oh, fire truck. Oh, yeah.
This the sound. Look. This the sound that we don't want to hear. You know what I mean?
Not at all.
Hey, right now, man, I got to show love to a guy, man. He's making a lot of impact in the city right now. Y'all can walk out if y'all want to, ladies. I didn't know if y'all was standing there, y'all was chilling, or if y'all was just trying to get back. Okay, no problem. Hey, right now, we got a brother in the building that's no stranger to controversy. And he reports the hoodest of hood news.
Somebody got to.
Shit. We talking about my man DMV hoods and news in the motherfucking building, baby.
Uptown, run the town.
Know what he say? Hey, man, listen. I'm surprised you let motherfuckers know where you reside. Because, bro, you keep it to keep it funky with you, man. You are no stranger to controversy.
Man, what?
Man, but you break some very unique content to the game, bro. Mm-hmm. Talk about who you are, man. Tell people who is DMV Hoods and News, man.
All right, man. This is your boy, Aaron Weezy, man, a.k.a. DMV Hoods and News, man. Coming from uptown D.C., Elm Street original, man. Leroy Park, First Street area. You know what I'm saying? That's where I come from, born and raised. Okay. That area way uptown, man. You know what I'm saying? Come up from the go-go culture and everything like that, was a promoter and everything like that. I wanted to do something different, so I just thought of an idea of bringing news. Really, DMV Hoods and News really started as just showing the neighborhoods and in the culture and stuff like that.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, and then it started to, once the DMV rap scene started to grow, then I just started talking about the drama and everything that started going on from there. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I like about you, though? You know how we have DMV followers, mm-hmm. how they was trying to cover DC, but they cover it like they don't show the raw stuff. They don't show what's really, like, really happening, getting down and gritty. Like, that's why I really like you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you cover everything. Like, the what's going on in the hoods, what's going on in the city, period.
You have a big following.
Yeah, something slight, man. It's growing. Hopefully, I can get to 100,000 soon, man.
You know? Man, it's coming. Just keep on pushing that content. Really.
You are most notably known for... I got the flash drive. Okay, I got something for y'all, too. We're going to talk about that in a minute. But you are most notably known for breaking stories that happen. And sometimes the people that you break these stories on don't be very happy. Let's get into one of them. Go to one of the DMV hoods and news right now. Which one? Just play one. Shit, it don't matter. I gave two top ones.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, we gonna play some of his newest
I can't
content.
Stay listening to
let's play one of them.
I just started to burn sometimes.
Let's play some of his newest content. Let's rock.
Just for you, before they can show y'all that they want, that they did go on the truck, on your truck, Slim.
Hey, man, you gotta step back.
I'm back. I'm just recording.
All right, you call you want to.
I can't see. I'm trying.
All the time, man. It's your boy DMV Hudson News right here reporting live, aka the motherfucking page that Money Reek hates the motherfucking most. He hates the shit out of my page, bruh. You know what I'm saying? I think I got C Pleasant on my ass now, man. I think C Pleasant want to beat the shit out of me now. Damn, man. Damn, C Pleasant. I like C Pleasant, man. I bang with C Pleasant, man. Damn, C Pleasant. What happened, y'all? I thought we was good. I show C Pleasant love all the time. It's all good, man. Shout out C Pleasant, though, man. You know what I'm saying? But y'all don't even know what happened, but that's a long story, man. Whole time, straight to the story, man. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. Don't forget to also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DMV Hudson News. We went straight to the motherfucking story. So, motherfucking Big Davo, man. Artist coming out of DC, man. He did a hot song, man. It just hit 100K, man, with OTD Don Bino. Free Don Bino, man. You know, he had to go back in the cell or whatever, you know what I'm saying, for his previous charge, man. You know what I'm saying? Free Don Bino, man. He's going to be out in a couple, in a little while, shit like that. But straight to the story, though, man. You know what I'm saying? You know, police try to raid the joint, man. Just try to raid the joint a couple of days ago where he shot the video at because they tried to say there were real guns in there. Although they were props. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? They didn't find no type of real guns or any crazy shit like that. They didn't find nothing in there. But that's what they said. So they tried to send the ATF. They tried to send the Federales. They tried to send the motherfucking Boys in Blue. They tried to send ABC, AB, 1, 2, 3. They tried to send everybody, man. They sent my grandma up that motherfucker, bro. You know what I'm saying? They sent my grandma, man. Motherfucker was looking for guns at that motherfucker. They sent everybody up that bitch, man. Whole time, man. But, yeah, man. I mean, it's just that whole situation just straight crazy, man. That situation just crazy, man. My thing is this, man. Whole time, my thing is this, man. If you're a video man, you gotta be careful how you position guns, because it might make it seem way that it's real or something like that. So if you see a registration number, don't post the registration number. Of course, I think y'all mostly know that. Another thing is, even if the registration number is scratched out or some shit like that, you know what I'm saying? Then make sure, like, don't even show that either, because it will insinuate that it's real and it'll probably give them a probable cause to come in and check a place out and shit. Don't put no signs and shit saying G-Lock or anything like that. Don't put no nothing. Don't put none of that shit. Don't, if it has a name brand on it, even though it's a prop, don't show that either, because then they're going to insinuate that it's real. So y'all got to be careful, man. And Gun Squad been showing their ass off lately, man. Y'all see these motherfuckers lately, man? They been showing their ass off for real, man. Gun Squad been on their shit, man, this summer, man. Checking niggas nuts and all type of gay shit. Checking niggas nuts and shit. Down motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Northeast motherfucker, been on the Sheriff Road and shit. Motherfucker pressing the young niggas out.
Hey, he ain't lying. Around my way right now, they pressing us out like every day.
You post a clip or what? Like what?
I just posted a clip. Yeah, we go the same fed that we talking about.
Oh, man. They uptown now, man. They uptown, man.
They
right on George Avenue.
They try to move around.
Personal conversation.
Really,
like, yeah, they uptown around and shit. Right? Listen, man, but we gotta keep it a brick, man. That shit ain't nothing new. They was uptown when we was on the bricks. But young dudes don't have no respect, man. At least when we saw the Bodines when we was coming,
I mean, yeah, we got saucy with them, and we tried to put hands on them if the jump outs acted like they got out of pocket.
Yeah.
But in the same token, these dudes be on social media every chance they get. Fuck 12.
Yeah.
Fuck 12. And police is on social media. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times they waiting for an opportunity. Okay, it's fuck 12. Bet. We got your ass. Mm-hmm. What happened to moving in silence a lot of the time?
You mean as far as the people, or you talking about as far as the
Everybody. Nobody moves in silence anymore.
I guess
you good, I got
people,
you, bro. We good.
I guess people just frustrated, you know what I'm saying, with the nonsense that's going on, so they basically want to put it out on the internet. Like, we're tired of the frustration, because this has been going on. This is nothing new. You know, I used to get pressed out around my way on Elm Street, you know what I'm saying, all the time. And I ain't never get into no trouble. None of the, like, police would pull up. Like, the same Golden Crown Vic would pull up, you know what I'm saying, and harass me, you know what I'm saying, trying to look for guns. I ain't never owned a gun a day in my life, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, they just harass people, you know, all type of crazy stuff. So people just get, you know, frustrated and tired, so they want to speak out. Since they got the social media and the Black Lives Matter stuff going on, I guess they feel like they need to speak out on that and so forth. You know what I'm saying?
Social media, period, you know, it just like when this people have it nowadays, it's like you go and record or just do anything. Like a person could be dying, and the first thing, instead of helping them, they're going to start recording.
Oh, yeah, man.
Man, like, do you want to know some real life shit, though? You got to understand something. Again, this shit is about guns. There's a lot of violence going on in the city right now. You dudes keep posting pistols and AKs and shit that we ain't supposed to have. We ain't supposed to have this shit. And y'all posting that shit on. Y'all give the people a motherfucking reason to be on your ass.
Mm-hmm, facts.
So then you get mad at another motherfucker and accuse him of snitching. But you gave them all the evidence on social media.
Facts. Oh, man.
Talk to them. I mean, like, talk to them.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you, though. I'm seeing on your IG that you know, you said that you were the most hated. Being the most hated, what keeps you going?
What keeps me going?
Yeah.
I guess I just love for the, you know, just a love for the city, love for the area and so forth. You know what I'm saying? Regardless of, you know, who dislikes me, who likes me or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, you know, this type of platform is needed at the end of the day. I feel like it's needed.
Most definitely, bro. And street speaking straight from my heart, bro, I fuck with you. Fuck a hater. Like, we all got haters. Yeah. Right. You know what I'm saying? If you don't got haters, then you ain't doing nothing right.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
And,
so.
And another thing is, if I post something bad about you or it's something like that, it's nothing personal or stuff like that. It's got to report it. Like, me not reporting it, it makes me look bad at the same time. Right. So it's like, you know, it makes me look bad at the same time. So I can't be biased and so forth. I get into it with artists every day. Oh, you posting these.
You get death threats. We're going to be honest. Do you get death threats or do you get threatened or do dudes want to get confrontation?
I would say death threats, but definitely confrontation. I got a confrontation with a couple artists too. You know what I'm saying? Well,
you literally had to get into a.
Like, I got into a situation where robbers came up on me 20 deep. Like, what's up with that? You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Facts. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't no sucker, but I ain't stupid either. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, yeah, real life. The smart man is the man who thinks wisely in a situation like that. So how did you dismantle or diffuse a situation like that?
I mean, basically, I just can't collect. But, you know, you're dealing with a bunch of hood dudes, you know what I'm saying, with guns. You know, you definitely gotta be careful because any little thing, and they drunk too. You know what I'm saying? And they,
right.
You know, drunk off alcohol, so you don't know what they got, guns, knives, or whatever. So you just basically gotta play their position, whatever. You know, you just whatever happens, you just gotta take that L. But as long as you can walk out with your life, then you know that's the most thing that matters. You know what I'm saying? But end of the day, you know, once people sober up and so forth, I get in contact with them personally, like, dang, what's up with that? You know what I'm saying? And they be like, oh man, we was drunk. You know, this, that, and the third, man. You know. We wasn't thinking, you know what I'm saying? I was like, man, this is something you couldn't talk to me personally about if you had an issue. You know what I'm saying?
Mm. Do you ever fear for your life, though?
I wouldn't say fear. I fear the Most High. I fear the Creator of all that exists. You know what I'm saying? First and foremost. So at the end of the day, I would say more paranoid more than anything. I can't get on
you be looking at that motherfucking door, buddy. I'm a good judge of character. See, I come from the street too, so
yeah,
I watch.
I was doing this before Dan V. Hudson.
Yeah, because you was watching it because you from the street.
Yeah, I'm uptown born raised.
Everybody from the street does that. Like, that door means everything.
Yeah, so
you never sip your back to it. So I respect that. What you got to say, Rick?
No, I'm sitting here listening, man. I think this is the story that needs to be covered, you know what I'm saying? I hope all your followers tuning in, you know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, the motherfuckers that's hating, they got to realize you setting a platform for them. They should be thanking you, you know what I'm saying? Exactly. Like, as you build, you know, you can help them build. Rappers coming at you sideways, they should be paying you, you know, and you're not charging, you know, that much. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
you know?
So was there ever an instance where you were actually... like you shouldn't have put that up, or you felt bad for putting up some content?
And that's on the heels of my man out Chicago that got murdered, the blogger
Zach TV got murdered
in Chicago, man. Do you know
I was supposed to link up with an interview for him. I was supposed to bring him out DC too.
Wow.
Yeah, like I was supposed to link him out DC. I was about to send him the deposit for that too, you know what
wow
I'm saying? Yeah,
wow.
For real, I was gonna take him to the go-go.
Wow.
So what
Chicken
else you got going TCB. On like where you wanna take this?
I want to first ask the first question. So one thing was, I was doing like a lot of controversial stories before I really got into the interview scene and into the culture scene, which was mostly about hood beefs and stories. But everything that I ever talked about was public documentation and public record. So it wasn't nothing that wasn't known, you know what I'm saying? And another thing is that, you know, these days, and shout out my man, bro, Cap, he also brought this up too. He was like, these days, the police officers are our age. You know, they range between like 21 and 30. They grew up in these neighborhoods just the same way. You know, most of the cops come from D.C. or they come from the DMV. So they not stupid.
Some of the case, but you know, they also hiring these West Virginia police officers.
They hiring cops from out of town too.
Yeah, they hiring a lot of cops from out of town, but some of them are actually from out here. So none of them are stupid. And even if them people from out of town and so forth, you know what I'm saying, out of town and so forth, then the police officers that is from out here, they going to hip them or what's going on. You know, they not stupid. They not them regular fat donut eating bald head cops, you know what I'm saying, from back in the days. So my thing was, I wasn't really promoting the neighborhood beast just to like size it up, but it was just actually giving a piece of history of what's really going on in the city. You know what I'm saying? Now the biggest regret I would have is, like, you gotta remember, I'm from out here. So sometimes I know stuff that's actually really going on, and I might just like, dang, that really, oh, that's my man. You know what I'm saying? I would say too much. And I'm like, oh, hold on. Let me track that. I'll delete that video right there in particular. You know what I'm saying? So some of them are still up and some of them are actually put down. You know what I'm saying? Because it was just like, it was a lot of stuff that I knew personally what was going on for real. You know what I'm saying? And this, that, and the third. So, like, I was never trying to, you know, try to play police or nothing like that. You know what I'm saying? So
a lot of the artists, let's go to the next video. A lot of the artists, that's where they go with you at. Like, they think they hate on you, thinking that you are hating on them. When you just really reporting
news. I'm just really reporting news. Like if
it ain't no sides when you're a media, man. You got to just...
Let's go into that real quick, right here on the Eddie Kayne Show. Somebody said that's clutch. Like, you reporting on some real street shit.
Yeah.
Like, that shit can get real ugly.
Yeah, it definitely get ugly, man. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, in the day, that's a go-go story. That's a culture story. But
that shit really going on right now.
Yeah.
You know, some people going to look at you as an instigator, but that's why your content is prime. You know what I'm saying? Like you were saying, you know what not to go overboard with. Nah, so, you know, that just keep doing what you're doing.
But is that going overboard? You're talking about somebody snitching.
I mean, he talked about somebody snitching.
I agree with you.
He only out there.
But you know what? Yeah. I had somebody to go at me and say, damn, y'all doing the police job. And when XXX Tentacon, Tenacion, passed away.
Tentacion.
Excuse me, I fuck up everybody's name. But listen, when Holmes died, I shared a video of the dudes that was flashing the money.
Right.
I had a dude come on my page like, damn, y'all doing the police job, y'all sharing a video, and da 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 da. And I'm like, hold up, Holmes. I'm a personality/entertainment reporter. I'm reporting what's going on in the streets.
Right. They already put it. It's already in the public.
But they put the shit out there. You need to go and talk to that man. He the one that made the damn video. So what do you say about that of being an instigator?
I wouldn't really call myself. I mean, how can I really speak about something that's already in the public? You know what I'm saying? Like I said, it's stories that people send me that I don't report on because it's not in the public. It's strictly in the streets. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's more, like, when I report something, it's a lot more that I know that I actually don't
put out. You dumb it down, son.
I do not put out stuff that's only in the streets and stuff like that, or who shot who, or who did this.
That's crazy, yeah. Now, I saw that you showed a lot of love to Makaya.
Yeah, man.
The little girl that got.
That was just to the family of her, man.
Yeah, her mom's is real good people. Let me ask, and Mike D'Angelo, salute to you, brother. Let me ask you a question, man. What is it going to take for us to get... to stop the violence? Because we got violence in music, and we can really get into that with you.
Mm-hmm. Well, what can we actually do? I can't really say necessarily put the guns down for real, because, you know, we come from that situation where if we don't have a gun, we could get killed ourselves. You know, you try to, you know, like, I can't say that, but honestly, yeah, I mean, if you have an issue with a particular person, then, I mean, firstly, man, you know, deal with that in a different way. If y'all gotta catch the fade, But end of the day, as far as them youngest, man, them crash dummies, man, I was shocked, really. Like, when I saw the footage for real, man, and the way they were doing, like, they wasn't just shooting at some people that they had beef with. They were shooting basically at a block party.
And anybody.
Any and everybody. It was mothers, kids, old people.
Have we come to that?
I don't know. I guess they just had no respect for no type of human life, man. And that's sad. That's sad the way the city is going, you know.
People don't got no morals or codes, man.
Usually, even back in the days when the city was murder capital, it always stayed between the, most likely it stayed between the people that was in the streets. It never really jumped. You know what I'm saying? Not an old lady gets shot in her head, or a little, you know, 5-year-old girl. Maybe that might happen, like, by, you know what I'm saying, misfire or whatever, you know, by accident, but it was never the intentional target and so forth. Now it seems like they don't have no care for life at all. They even rap about it now. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely. Justice for Makaya and her family. I know, being a mom, a lot of us in here in the studio today are parents. So that's definitely the unthinkable. Yeah. It should not happen at all. But we're going to lighten it up a bit. I wanted to ask you, if we didn't have, you know, Instagram or social media, for you to be such a big social media sensation or the most hated, would you be still doing the same thing? Like, would you be still trying to get, you know, the real out there to the people?
Without any type of form of social media?
No, not without any type of form, but, like, you know, definitely Instagram is the go-to. Well,
my main page is a YouTube page.
So yeah, okay.
That's my main form of platform. Actually, my Instagram, my Twitter just got, you know, was just building up as soon as I started, you know, progressing in my YouTube channel and so forth. So now I'm now more than a YouTube channel. Now I have an Instagram and a Twitter, you know, and so forth. So I probably would still been doing my YouTube page and so forth, you know, if that was the only platform for me and so forth, you know. You know, but if I wasn't doing that, I'd probably been finding, you know, promotion of other things, you know, and so forth. Like I said, I used to be a go-go promoter.
Tell them where we at tonight.
Oh, you say, oh, yeah, we had the power, man. You know what I'm saying? Saturdays and so forth, man.
So you down power tonight, man. Tell them the address, Reek.
2335 Bladensburg Road, Northeast. We lit tonight. The weather ain't stopping us tonight, man. It don't rain in the club. Remember that.
Yeah. only money rain in the club.
Only champagne showers.
Exactly. Yeah. Let me say this, and we get ready to get the closing up. What do you? We got one more. We got to talk about a serious situation that occurred that you covered, which is also the situation with the Hood Rich Pablo Juan and the Rich Shooters. Man, I know you probably don't want to get too deep into it.
I mean, it's already out there, so it's not. It's nothing.
Did it cause a lot of drama for you?
You know what's crazy? You know, the management team contact called me personally. I was trying to figure out how they got my number. They called me personally, man. They said, man, because they was like, they didn't really have no issue with the chain snatching story, but they had another issue with something involving their artists and, you know, the artists that was from out here and so forth. And they had an issue with that, and they asked me to put that down because it's a little bit, you know, more
is it
to
police?
The story.
It's a little bit
more to the story. It's not like no police stuff, but they just wasn't really happy with that. They didn't really care about the chain snatching story and so forth, you know what I'm saying? Because it's already happened. It's already in the public. You know what I'm saying? They already know how the media, you know, goes.
So quick question. If you do an interview on a certain type of artist and they ask you to take it down, were you willing to?
Yeah, I took down a couple of videos.
You got to understand from the street aspect, it's a respect, it's a moral code to certain things that you have to do if it could impede somebody's freedom or if it could hurt them legally through some capacity. That's only law, man.
Yeah,
but I think that we've lost touch with the morals and character that character codes that we grew up with, because I see a lot of people don't respect those. You know, they don't respect the OG.
Mm-mm, not at all.
The youngest don't respect the OG. They don't have respect, self-respect.
Right.
Drugs has always been an issue, but we used to celebrate the drug dealer, then we turned into celebrating the drug addict.
Yeah,
it's weird. it's weird.
So what we do is have a city full of junkies, and you know, I am not innocent. I've done my deal in my time, but we have to sometimes sit back and think about things. Okay, this is where I'm going as I'm getting older and I'm starting to evaluate. We want to be we have Caucasian interns, but they have participated with me in talking about gentrification, so I don't want nobody to feel uncomfortable. But we have people that want to be, we as a community, want to be real-ass niggas.
Mm-hmm.
You want to be a real-ass nigga.
Right.
The personification within our community, we understand. That's a term of endearment.
Right.
But you want to be known as the realest nigga. That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
When you really sit back and think about it.
Yeah. That's
you think about it.
Mm-hmm.
Think about what I'm saying to you. In other situations, man, as men, we have demoralized our women.
Facts.
Well, we used to have songs that spoke of love. Now everything is a bitch in our community.
Mm-hmm.
But don't see, society is funny and it has a way of karma because it's not just in our community. You have it in other community. Other races are now following suit.
Exactly.
How do you put something positive back, a positive spin back into the situation? Because everything is negative. And like, that's what. Not and if you glorified positive, factual, you'll lose your fan base.
Mm-hmm. I wouldn't necessarily. Sometimes I want to like do more stories on more positive things in the community and so forth. But end of the day, my fan base came from what's the reality that's going on in the area. So I would like, that's one thing I am working on, is working on more community events and more things that's going on and so forth. I'd love to, you know, touch bases more on that. But you know. Basically, my fan base is mostly, you know, controversial stories and so forth. And also, not just controversial, it's reality. But that's something I'm personally working on and so forth. You know what I'm saying? Because I don't like the... Because, like, you know, whatever you think about me on my YouTube channel and stuff, so forth, I don't really be wanting none of this stuff to be happening. I don't want a 10-year-old.
It's not you that's doing it, though, bro.
Yeah.
It's not you doing it. You only giving us the news of what's going on. Because, like, some of these cats I learn about through you.
Right.
Same here.
I don't know. So just to let you know, people watching, because like, I don't even be knowing who some of these jokers is.
Right.
What you want
to
say, Rick?
I was about to say, like, people watching, believe it or not, even if they don't come up to you and tell you or something like that, at the end of the day, they're watching.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm letting you know, I'm watching, bro. Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, just keep doing what you're doing. Don't stop. And mix some positive with the negative. Yeah, definitely. That's so, definitely, you know.
Definitely. That's one of the biggest things that I would say to you. I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. I ain't trying to change what you do. Mm-hmm. Do your thing. Because that's what got me looking at you. You feel me? It's just from the retrospect, we got to do something as a community.
Facts.
Sunday, that's why I'm holding that 1,000 black men with love. Because we don't have no love in the community no more.
Right.
Slim, if I come up to you and you don't know me and I show you love, the first thing you think is I'm a sucker or I'm sweet. We can't even show. Or we. Go ahead.
That's crazy because, you know, growing up in D.C., you know, we grew up in the city. We can't trust nobody, man, not even your man. So, you know, me going down like somewhere down south or whatever, when they actually show you genuine love, you look at that like that's kind of weird, man. Like, what's going on for real?
Before
like,
we get into it.
You trying to set me up?
Yeah. You think of automatically, yeah, you think of like, somebody when they come genuinely, you thinking they trying to set you up. We're going to talk about that because I want to talk about this with my team. I want to get everybody's thoughts. Play the Gleesh interview from Vlad TV. Shout out Gleesh, DMV artist. Mm-hmm. A lot of y'all probably, if y'all was watching the Eddie Kayne show in the early days, you used to see Gleesh on my show with Fat Trail a lot. He used to be with the Slutty Boys.
Yeah, that's
my
man. I got like 2 songs with Gleesh.
Play this video with him, part one. Only on the Eddie Kayne show, WLVS radio, listenvisualize.com. Hey, before I get out of here, I'm going to let 2 performances go. My man Jag Money in the building and King Love It. We're going to let them both rock a single before we get out of here. Hey, you got the video for me? Let's go. On the Eddie Kayne show.
Do business with a nigga.
Man, that was Young Gleesh, man. Do you agree with a lot what he said about DC dudes?
I agree a lot the whole time, man. I agree a lot what he's saying, man. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was weird because, you know, Vlad told me about some, the crack area died after the mid. Nah, not where I grew up, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not, that's not nothing in the way to praise or nothing like that, man. Crack, PCP, all that stuff, man. That was very rampant in my area, you know what I'm saying? Even after the, like, even in the early 2000s and so forth, you know what I'm saying? When gentrification was in the beginning and so forth, you know what I'm saying? Everything like that, though. But I agree a lot with Gleesh says and so forth, man. He basically comes because me and him about the same age. We come from the same cloth, the same earth. You know what I'm saying? Everything like that. Even though we from 2 different sides. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
In closing, man, I'm gonna let my team rock out.
Hey, shout out my man Gleesh, though, man. Like. Me and Gleesh used to be, you know what I'm saying, the trap. Yeah, back
all,
in the day.
All y'all used to come up to
we
the Eddie Kayne
show. Came from the old
spot. If you remember, we used to be over there in Hinesville. Y'all remember coming over to my man Bruce's spot, and that's where a lot of the artists from the Slutty Boys, Fat Trail, Gleesh, Rick, who else? BJ Banks, everybody, Light Show, Garvey, Booby, every Rock Mikey, every DC rapper was. And that's when the Eddie Kayne show, we was over in Hinesville. So shout out to my man, Big Bruce over there, man, for showing us that love. Hey, say something, Patrice Perry.
No, I just wanted to tell him that I'd be his bodyguard.
Oh, for real? Oh, that's what's up.
Hey.
You gotta worry about that.
So we got a proposal for you.
Yeah.
Why don't you come through once a month, man, and give us the DMV hood news right here on the Eddie Kayne show, man, if you're willing to come through. And give it to us live. We're willing to help you to give you even more worldwide. You're already doing your thing. You don't really need us, but we want to give you a worldwide platform.
Man, definitely, man. That's what y'all want all the time. Because I always interact with my people and stuff, man. Everybody that's here. So if that's what they want, I'm going to give them what they want.
Hey, man.
Early.
Say something to them.
Man, come through, bro. Like, no bullshit. Like, we... like... This is going, we going to get big there. I see everybody right here in this room. You know what I'm saying? We going to grow. We going to take this shit to the next level.
Yeah, definitely. Push each other up.
And that's what I want to show love to DMV Hood Hoods and News for, man, because you remind me of me, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Self-made. Mm-hmm. I just want to show love. That's
appreciate
all it
that,
is,
man. Appreciate that. Sincerely.
Hey, man, I want you to link up with some of the people in the building. I want you to check out some talent because I want to see more talent on your
definitely,
page, too.
Definitely.
I want to see some more performances because you got that platform.
Mm-hmm.
Give the platform to these artists to perform, and we're going to talk about the business off the air. WLVS Radio, man. King Love and get ready to go to the stage right there. Hey, we get ready to bring my little bro Jag Money through. Hey, you can stay right there, man. I'm gonna slide on and go to the thirds and let Jag come through real quick. We're going to just introduce this video after King Love it before we go to the top 17 video countdown. We got right now in the building, hopefully to be a part of the family, DMV Hoods and News. Would you prefer to call by your real name or DMV
you
Hoods?
Call me Ann Weezy. You call me Ann Weezy.
Ann Weezy. Let's call him Ann Weezy. Okay. Because that's how I hear you call yourself on the video. You ready to get into it? Go on the stage, Holmes. You ready to get into it right now?
Yeah.
Take this. We're going to let my man King. He performed this the other night. My man Jag Money's birthday party. We had a great time down there.
Shout out Jag Money.
So I thought it was only proper that we do it like this. Only right here on the Eddie Kayne Show. Tell the people where they can find you at, home.
On Instagram, King_LoveIt_DCM, Drama City Music. That's my little record label I'm trying to get up off the ground. But I don't do all the extra stuff. I just let the music speak for itself, man. What song you got, though? You got Baby?
Let's get into it right here on the Eddie Kayne Show.
Shout out Swab Beats, too.
I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby. You make a better me, I think you my destiny. I'm the king, you the queen, yeah, the realest on my team. You can even see my dreams, but you never let me sleep. Cause you know we got to eat, all them goals we gon' see. And the odds we gon' beat, we're like a special recipe. Or the right remedy, no matter what the winning team. Only mission is the green, yeah, them papers or them trees. Backwoods will do us good, cause we're hella coming from east of the river. No lions, tigers, or bears. Just hustlers, dealers, and killers. Taught to get it on our own. Drama City raises realers. So I hustle so gorilla. My wife, my realest nigga. I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby. Behind every good man stands a stronger woman. Between behind me, you beside me. Yeah, you my gunner, my lover. That's why I never use a rubber. You gon' be my baby mother. Even if you drive me crazy, you know I'ma keep it silent. Even help you with your body. Gotta keep it looking proper. Stretch marks, my little tiger. Come here so I can bite you. This forever, no one night. I want my kids up inside you. And I put it on the Bible. My mama, you my rider. I see heaven when I look deep inside you. I've been conscious, but baby, I look at you as a goddess. You a goddess, yeah, together you know we got it. Ain't no problems too big, yeah, we can solve more. I kick more ass than Stone Cold Steve Austin, yeah, ain't no talking. Cause baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby, you the best in me. I think you my destiny. My only goal for us to eat. Yeah, I said, baby. Yeah, I said, baby. Yeah, I said, baby.
Shout out Eddie Kayne, man. I appreciate it, man.
Only on the Eddie Kayne Show, man. Tell them one more time where they can find you, big dog.
King_LoveIt_DCM on IG. That song is going to be my first single. I'm pushing it on iTunes next month. So just stay tuned. I got a whole EP ready. But I got to get y'all attention first before I drop that fire on y'all.
Yeah, keep going. You sound like Lil Boosie a little bit.
Everybody, hey, look. I got a mixtape coming out. He sound like Boosie. Everybody who hear me, say that. So after the EP drop, that's the first mixtape I'm going to put out.
He sound like Boosie.
He sound like Boosie.
Hey, man, that's King Love It, man, right here on the Eddie Kayne Show. Hey, DMV Hoods and News show them big love. Hey. I think you fit right on in, Playboy. Look at you. You looking, you having a good time. You can't deny it, boy. You can't deny it. Look at it. He can pull it on it. Hey, it's all good, bro. That's what you need sometimes. Hey, we got the boy Jag Money in the building next to my man, My main man. Let's talk to him, man. What's going on with you, Holmes? You are no stranger to the WLVS radio family.
Yes,
you used
sir,
to be
yes,
a
yes,
radio
sir.
Personality, but you are an artist.
Yeah.
You had a great party the other night down at Tropicalia, man. Tell the people who you are.
Oh, man, Jag Money, the man of many styles. I mean, you know, you might know me from DMV Talks. You might know me as King Fabio. You might know me just being a popular guy through D.C. I had the jukebox popping. I'm known for actually doing phenomenal parties. You know, I'm known for a lot of things, man. You know, I'm starring in a couple films. You know, I've been doing this thing for a minute, man. You know, rest in peace to my guy, Bishop Twan. You know, he was one of the guys who introduced me to Eddie Kayne a long time ago, and we've been actually, you know, making a lot of noise in this city, man. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, you know, yeah, we done came a long way, you know. Got a lot going on, man. How you been?
Man, welcome to the Eddie Kayne Show. You see, things have changed.
Yeah, yeah, I see, man. You
got
know what I'm saying?
A whole new squad up here.
Yeah,
well,
yeah.
We're moving on up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what's up, though, man.
Hey,
for real.
I got
real.
Patrice Pyrie and my man Remix Reek in the building. Talk to him real quick, y'all.
Man, nice to meet y'all, man, for real.
Same here, definitely. Good to
so
have you.
So, you said you do jukebox?
I did the jukebox was going on for about 2.5 years. It was a show, one of the hottest shows actually for independent artists. And it was designed for actually the artists to make money. We used to have a lot of different acts in there, a lot of most of the hot acts that come from out DMV, but we did it once a month. And it was a real, real phenomenal turnout. We did that for like about 2.5 years straight. A lot of people know me for that, you know. And not only that, it helped a lot of artists. It helped change a lot of things as far as for artists too, because, you know, like we made it the way as though like the artist was able to make money other than just paying or, you know, like really not getting no type of opportunity or nothing out the deal. And not only that, I made sure that I had like the ladies in there. Like I made sure I had like the people in there other than you just performing for your mans and them. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't nothing like that. It was real organized, man. You know what I'm saying? So everything that I do, it be, you know, like a theme tour, just like the Coming to America show we just did. That was Thursday up Tropicalia. You know, Eddie Kayne had hosted that. And usually Eddie Kayne or even Bishop Twan host majority of my birthday parties or whatever. But yeah, man, you know, it was a real phenomenal experience. Straight up.
Yeah, definitely. Would you say what you do is a way that you can, you know, give back to your community?
Yeah, of course. I mean, to be honest, you it ain't too many DMV rappers out here who don't owe me some money or a favor. You know what I'm saying? And I ain't saying that to be cocky. I'm just being real. You know what I'm saying? You know, I didn't did a lot for a lot of these artists. You know what I'm saying? I did a lot for a lot of these comedians. You know what I'm saying? Just as far as like helping them get on a platform, sharing my platform with them. You know, yeah, I mean, Eddie definitely vouched for that. You know what I'm saying? You know, I definitely did a lot for these guys as far as even when I was here. I had the DMV Talks here show here. It was a really, really good show. Shouts out to DJ Boom. You know, and shouts out to my partner. Shouts out to my guy, Wavy. Shouts out to Wavy. You know what I'm saying? But yeah.
Wavy, what's up?
Yeah, we definitely it was like when we came up here, it was like a party every Tuesday then we was doing something, you know what I'm saying? So a lot of people used to come up there and we had an invitation for everybody, anybody who got something going on. A lot of people who used to come straight out of jail used to come straight to my show. You know, hey man, I'm trying to do this, so I got a book coming out, or I'm trying to do this, you know.
So
like,
what
so
you
it
got
was,
going on now? Like,
oh my lord.
Weekly.
Oh well, right now, I'm starring in like about 2 films. I also, I always got a show going on. I have I just did the Coming to America. I got, my next show is going to be the Harlem Nights. So it's going to be Harlem Nights theme. I actually started a movement called the Good Dad Gang. And what's that about is basically, I'm not really trying to go too far in it, but you know, it's basically like a representation of good fathers who can't like see their kids or who can't like be a good dad. Or can't be a father at all. You know what I'm saying? It's like it's a movement that I had started, but I have a event, like a cookout that I'll be definitely doing. I think I'm gonna be doing that like in September. I got a pool party coming up as well. You know, and I also got some new music that I'm dropping. We won't get into that as well. You know, I got a new project that I'm working on called Kinglish. I don't talk English no more. I speak English. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, you know, I got that going on. I mean, I always got something going on, you know, like for real. And not only that, you know, like my everyday life, I manage events for bigger companies, you know what I'm saying? So I actually just came off a tour with Swisher Sweet, and I be actually doing an artist project for them. So I also have that going on as well. You know, and not only that, I also have somebody, shouts out to Tyra. I also brought King Lovett up here too, because he had did a phenomenal job at his at my party the other day. But Tyra, she basically, I got some things going on with her as well, as far as, you know, helping people build their credit and get homes and all that type of stuff, man. You know what I'm saying?
So, sound like you a busy man.
Yeah, real busy, man. You know what I'm saying? For real. You know, I had a lot.
That's what's up, though.
Yeah, I got a lot going on. And not only that, I've been through so much, man, coming from Southeast D.C., you know what I'm saying? You know, you got to stay busy out here, man, because, you know, like, shit, you one day you here, next day you gone, man. You know what I'm saying? For real. So, you know, it's all about what you did or what you do while you here. You know what I'm saying? And me, time is my most precious asset. I ain't got no time to waste. You get?
So what or who are your biggest influences?
Say it again.
What or who are your biggest influences?
Well, to be honest, I ain't just saying that because I'm on his show, but definitely Eddie Kayne played a big role in and a lot of the things that it is that I do. Me watching him, man, Bishop. I remember the day that Bishop had chose me. I had one like this. I think it was like a freestyle or something like that. But I burnt a couple people up. You know what I'm saying? And Bishop was like, man, I gotta take you on a show, man. So he sent me to the show, and I met Eddie Kayne. You know what I'm saying? And I was just a young cocky dude from the street. You know what I'm saying? Rapping what he was living and living what he was rapping. You know what I'm saying? And Eddie Kayne is the first thing he said to me. He was like, "Man, you one of the cockiest motherfuckers I ever met in my life, but I like you, little nigga. Like, I like you though. Like, you know what I'm saying? You're a good little dude, and you got some confidence with you. You know what I'm saying? From that day, you know what I'm saying, to see how much he grew, because he ended up getting his own show, which is the Eddie Kayne Show, which is what we on right now. He ended up actually doing a lot of other things, and not only that, he started doing a lot of shows, and we started actually working together. So a lot of watching his come up, watching Bishop come up, like we actually seeing each other come up, you know what I'm saying? So those guys, I definitely would say, you know, inspired a lot with me. A lot of my inspiration come from the streets too, you know what I'm saying? Those phenomenal, those neighborhood superstars, you know what I'm saying? You know, those kids who really don't have no voice or nothing like that, you know what I'm saying? But they got phenomenal stories, you know what I'm saying? I got a lot of inspiration files from my parents as well, you know what I'm saying? But mainly I would definitely say, you know, it more come from the people who it is who I know, you know what I'm saying? I hate to say it, but, you know, like, I lost my father at a young age, so, like, you know, the neighborhood embraced me, so it was just certain people who came up from my neighborhood and throughout the city who just legendary people who I just watched do their thing and made me just want to do mine, you know what I'm saying? Put my name on this world and starting just with my neighborhood, then the city, then the nation, then the world, you know what I'm saying?
So do you have anything to say for other guys, well, guys coming up in this generation, millennials, I guess, that may have lost their dads to, you know, incarceration or something else that, you know, may not be taking that, using that to their advantage to, you know, up their career for themselves?
Well, what I say is, man, stay down. That's how you come up. You know what I'm saying? You know, educate yourself, you know? Unlearn the bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Unlearn the bullshit, you know what I'm saying? Like, straight up, understand that, you know, to be a black man in America, you have to understand just what that is. And not only that, the only way that you gonna really be able to change anything, you gotta change your mindset, you know what I'm saying? Train yourself to, you know, it's not easy, but train yourself to, you know, to master your emotions, you know? Like I was just telling this young man right here, you know, shit, stay busy, man, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, understand that you have a story, you know?
Hey, we have, hey, boom, did you move the stuff that we have? I'm sorry, Jack. Did you move the stuff we had for the benefit, boom?
Yeah, where the shit at, boom?
It was at the front right there. It was some water and stuff that was sitting right there. It's still right there? Okay, there's a lady out front trying to deliver something. Y'all mind going out there and help that lady? Hey, I thought you moved it because I couldn't see it no more. Hey. Oh, I believe you did. Hey, Jack, man, we really appreciate you, man. You inspire a lot of dudes, man.
I appreciate you, brother.
Where can they find you at on social media?
At the Jag Money Show. You can catch me at the Jag Money Show. Everything spelled correctly. You know what I'm saying? At the Jag Money Show on Twitter. You can actually follow me on Facebook. I don't ever really give out my Facebook page like that, but you know, if you know me, then you know me. Like what Pusha T say, if you know, you know. Yeah, man, you know. But yeah, y'all can definitely look me up on Instagram, on YouTube, or just Google me. Google Jag Money, King Fabio, you know what I'm saying? I'm out here, man, for real.
Hey, that's love to you, bro. We can write world premiere your video right now.
Oh,
now,
man, that's love.
This dude right here was supposed to be here at 1 o'clock. It is 3 o'clock. He is too... Old Bam 640, man. I swear to goodness, man. Old Bam 640. Hey, we can write world premiere this video right now. WLVS Radio, Listen Vision. I appreciate y'all, fellas. God knows I do. WLVS Radio, you want to introduce the video, bro?
Yeah, man. Actually, this is coming off of my project that I got called Kinglish. You know, it's called God Bless. And to be honest, it's a lot of meaningful things that happened in this video. This is actually like a real day in my life. Like, it's nobody else in the video. It's like a real, real day of like what it is that I was actually doing. So I hope that y'all love it, man, because it's very authentic, man, for real. Authentic DC street shit, straight up. You know what I'm saying?
All right. We're going to do this, man. We're going to bring Bam 640 through after this. And then right there from that, we're going to the top 17 video countdown sponsored by Cloud9 Vodka. Y'all ready, gang?
Yeah, we ready.
Y'all ready. Let's get into it right now, man. This is the world premiere. What's the name of the video?
God Bless.
God Bless. Jag Money, only on the Eddie Kayne Show. Let's rock.
Let's go. It don't matter what situation you get in. I mean, it is.
JMG shit.
Well, you got it, you got it. Don't.
Baby,
Once I lead a crime scene, I ain't gon' leave no witness. I'm in DC selling cocaine out the LA Fitness. In this dope game business, you can't trust a fucking soul. Call me Bruce Lee, boy, how I karate chop the dope, nigga. Roll it, light it, nigga, smoke the shit. I'm somewhere ice skating with my Nova Scotia bitch. Yeah, I got models in Milan, Cuban cigar in my mouth, gold chopper like Saddam. Make a mad bitch calm. Once I hit her with the charm, bought a house with my wrist. Know you see what's on the arm. Wow. The way I get the powder off. These bitches think a nigga hit the Powerball. That man, I'm so outlandish with it. They call me Jag, but Fabio to all the Spanish bitches. These fiends be catching temper tantrums with it. I sell it how it is, my nigga, I don't tamper with it. Meth lab, white boys in the camper with it. Motherfucker, I'm on fire, JoJo dancing with it. Wah! Motherfucker, I'm on fire, JoJo dancing with it. God bless all the trap niggas. Yeah, nigga used to trap with you. Now I made it out the trap, yeah, made it out the trap. But now I'm back for all my trap niggas. God bless all the trap niggas. Yeah, nigga used to trap with you. Now I made it out the trap, yeah, made it out the trap. But now I'm back for all my trap niggas. I ain't just hit the 10 crack commandments, I obey them. If DC is crabs in the borough, I obey them. The ones we had to kill, they names we don't say them. Girl cooking got the boy in the rice, I'm just saying. Ask your boy, I'm like Floyd with the dice, you won't fade him. I might take your wife for the night, but I won't save her. Connect, acting funny, he know I do no plan. He needed more attention, the reason we no pay him. My name a landmark in the city like Ben Shelley. How a homecoming, you lunching, I been Diddy. 40 cow with me, you silly, I been pretty. Married to the riches and bitches that been with me. God bless all the trap niggas. Yeah. The whole VA, the whole DMV, man. Let's get it.
Hey, that's your man King Doja right there, right? What's your man right there with the hat on? You was what's your name, bro?
King Love.
King, no, the brother right here with the, you, bro. You was out like.
He
looked like, well, I seen him in the party the other day. Salute to you, brother. Oh, that's your manager. Salute, manager. He don't got no name, just salute, manager. What's up, man? Huh?
That's Crack Son.
Yeah. Oh, boy, you done grown up, boy. You done grown up. You was young last time I seen you. You was junior. Now you got a whole head full of face and shit. Damn, boy, you a Kush boy. Okay. All right, Cap City Kush boy. Salute, boy. God damn, I'm getting old. He okay? been knowing your daddy a brick. Boy, you was riding a bicycle when I knew your daddy, boy. Salute to your pop, man. That's my man. Hey, that old boy sat there, puffed that damn cigar, boy, got him there. Boy, he ain't getting no cancer, didn't he? That boy was over there sucking. He was blowing that motherfucker like a true boss, wasn't it? Hey, WLVS Radio, thisbitchlive.com, the Eddie Kayne Show. I got DMV Hood News riding with us right now. Got CEO Reek in the building and Patrice Pottery.
And we at Power tonight.
Forget. Hey, we live right now on iHeartRadio, Google Play Music, and Spotify. Make sure you go to all three platforms and download the Eddie Kayne Show via WLVS Radio. Hey! That boy Bam 6 foot. Bring your ass in. You need a that, and you need bring your ass over here, man. And you need a special introduction. Come on, let's do a motherfucking special introduction for Bam. Get your ass on over here, boy. Bam 640, my man. 50 grand. That boy terrible, man. Jesse, he's supposed to have been there at 1 o'clock, man. What happened, bro?
I came from Woodbridge, man. I had a hard. You know how Washington Post is. I ain't gonna fake like I ain't got no regular job.
Hey, that boy got it. He got a radio show. He do it real big in the DMV. You got to show him some love.
Right.
And you everywhere, son.
I'm trying. Keep the grind up. Just keep focused, man. No matter what, just got to keep grinding. God's plan. God lead the way. Just keep going.
Man, that's God. Hey, you use that as your motto, too, bro. Right. That's big love to you, man. Tell the people who you are, man, because you come right up the block. You done changed your life, but you come from up the block.
Yeah, I'm coming up the block, 640 Park Road. Rest in peace, Easy to God. King Shug, Googlizzy, and all my homies that's doing their thing on the rap side, too. But, yeah, 640 Park Road, that's where we at.
And see, a lot of people don't even know your plight. You was battling an illness.
Right.
And still managed to outwork a lot of people, man. People was... clowning was like, man, he ain't have his teeth. They don't know you had talk to him and tell him what happened. So they'll be.
Oh, the diabetes when I first found out I had diabetes, I didn't even know. I was just like, I kept drinking a lot of water, but I was still dehydrated. I'm like, just when I was going to go radio, I was like, I'm still dehydrated. I done drunk a whole gallon of orange juice. I'm still dehydrated. I drank a whole gallon of water. I'm still dehydrated. So I went to the Washington Hospital Center. Because Tori took me to Washington Hospital Center because she from uptown, too. Right. And then I'm like, man, your sugar at 1,500. You this close to death. You ain't supposed to be walking right now. So that's what
1,500,
happened.
1,500, bam.
1,500. I didn't even know I had diabetes, though.
Wow. You didn't let it take you down, though, bro. And I salute you for that, man, because you kept fighting, man. And to be honest, you outworked a lot of these dudes, man.
Man, I always say, it's good to be humble. I say it's a lot of dudes that's lyrically better than me in the DMV. That's why I respect Bill, Shaw, Guapo, D Black, even Tripe Game, and all the other people that's doing their thing, young about that. But I just feel like no DMV rappers, because I work me, because I get up and I treat this shit like a job, like every day, like I'm always pumping. And most of my hosting gigs or most of my pay gigs I get, it's not off or just talent alone. They like, if we put Bam in the joint, we know he going to pump the shit out of this joint. He going to sell tickets. He going to blast it on the radio and everything. So that's where it come up with that. It's just the hard work. It's not just, he on. Nah, because they know I'm going to blast the show more than anybody that's on that show. So that's basically
what it is. Hard work and consistency brings success. It's the recipe.
So I see in your bio it says official IG rapper. What's that about?
No, I just said official. That's my official page, but I got Team 640. I got a different MySpace, but that's my.
You said MySpace? You go back to. You was a hustler. You still using MySpace?
No, I said official.
Oh, I thought you said MySpace. I wish I was. Damn, Bam. I wish I. Shit, I need to go get that motherfucker back.
I can't remember my password on MySpace.
Hey, you want to say something to him, DMV Hoods and News? You probably not familiar with the brother, but see,
I looked him up. I followed him. One thing I know. See, people don't understand to be on a Eddie Kayne show or Eddie Kayne even artist show. It's a privilege. Like I said, I tell Eddie Kayne, I respect my whole Kasana is doing shows. Is what I seen him in district. Bishop Twan do the DC soundstage and to the Pearl Lounge every Sunday, to the museum. I sit there and watch them guys. And I'm not ashamed that I said I learned the game from Eddie. I tell him this all the time. I learned the game from you, and I learned how to pass back with the people I'm working with to keep pushing them though.
Hey, and I salute you for it, man. And you always do that, man. And I pay homage to you because right. you do. You know, a lot of people will get alley-oop off of you
right.
and won't even show you no kind of love, Joe. You know what I mean? Or forget all about you. And there's a lot of artists that I done put in play to help them get to the next level. Right. And they never reach back. But, you know, you are one who will go on your live and everything, man.
Because you got to respect. Whenever a dude can have a show at 2 o'clock in the morning, people set their DVR and lead a club early to come in. That's the big... That's a big privilege. Even the joint you did with Backyard Out of Atlanta and everything. Like every time I go out of Atlanta, and people say, "Oh, you go out of Atlanta, make a big." Nah, you got to put the work. But if they constantly see you in Atlanta, they see a different face. They was I went to Top Ends. I've been to AUMA Radio, and they all know who you is. They know who you're on, what your show is, what you did at AC3, and now I mean. The whole BNB
and TV weekend. Had a TV show on a,
yeah.
On,
that's why I said you did the jump with Backyard. Yeah. Official jump with Backyard. I love that interview. That's one I really see the interview that you really ask them questions that anybody else don't ask them. So that's just a salute to you though.
I mean, hey man, salute to you. You get a lot of hate.
Yeah.
But you're able to push through. And you turn your hate into a lot of love because a lot of people show you big love.
Yeah, but anyway, like I say, Big G is my biggest inspiration. He tell me that people going, his number one motto is said, "This what the fuck I signed up for, and this what the fuck I'm gonna do." So at the end of the day, you gotta know what you signed up for.
That's the realest shit you can say, man.
Yeah, you gotta know what you signed up for. You gotta know. It's going to happen to you, but in a sense, like I said, it's God's plan because we all wanted to be big. We've been big years ago, so I followed God's lead and I continue to show love because only He could judge, not me, and I still show the love and I get it back. So you know what I'm saying? So everything good.
Bam, you travel the damn country. You in Miami, North Carolina.
Shout out Miami.
You in Miami, North Carolina. You real heavy on the go-go circuit.
Right.
How did that come to be?
The go-go circuit, that's just from Big So Big G and Buzz. I mean, that's just a shout out to them that plug me in with the go-go. But I never even thought I could host. Like, once they said, we gonna put the mic in your hand, you could talk shit. And then when I kept going, I said, I really like this. And I just kept going with it. I kept going. Like, everything I do, like, everybody know this shit is like it's a lane, but you can rap. You can do the radio. You can do the community thing. You can do everything. But everything, you got to be genuine. And once you be genuine and really know that you love the city, like, no matter what my city, some niggas hate on me, some niggas back, but I got love for Washington, D.C. I got love for Alexandria, Virginia. I got love for P.G. Maryland. As long as you keep doing that shit and they know it's from the heart, God going to take care of everything else.
Yeah, so for the people who don't know you, who is
BAM640? BAM 640 just, man, he just a 640 dude that works hard every day.
Break to who is 640?
Who? 640 Moore Street, 640 Park Road, Park Moore and Apartments. I mean, I love that place because like me, my father wasn't shit. So the OGs respected my mother coming up. Like, nah, we ain't going to put that pack in your hand. We ain't going to do this. We ain't going to do this. You can hold something like this. And you know what I'm saying? It's just they just molded me and wasn't all bad. And Big G was one of those people that molded me. I mean, I hung on 14th Street, like, or really uptown. Like, I love some uptown. That's why I support Tay. I support Tay, Goo, and all them youngs. To see them doing good. People might hate on them. That shit, like, amazed me. Me and Suge was just out Miami together. And he back out Miami. He did a show at Senior Frogs. They liked him so much, they brought him back out here this week. Now he doing a Mar Stoudemire show out there this weekend. So that's just shout out to him. Just long as it ain't even gotta be me. Long as somebody from the city progress, I'm happy with that. You know what I'm saying? I'm happy with
you
that.
You sound like me, man. I just wanna see us do good. You know, the whole city as a whole, you know, at least somebody, like, you know. That's what's wrong with our mentality, though. You know, it's a lot of hate. People don't scared to show love here, but, you know, I'm right. Glad you came through and I met you. I'll go by Remix Reek, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I look at you. You got all the views. I mean, it's just like, if I wasn't in this whole Forever Legendary album and I screenshot, yo, like a day before Twan died, he said, I don't care what nobody say. You a DMB legend in my eyes. And that shit just rang with me. Like, everywhere I go, I have to, you don't want to try to put that label on you, but when so many people like Buzz, Big G, Chuck Brown, Daughter KK put that label on you, you start to say, okay, maybe I am, but you could say it in another way, you know? So, I mean, that's about it.
Man, listen, accept it and run with it. Fuck what anybody else got to think or say about that shit, man. We rocking with you.
Right.
Go ahead. Listen, man.
Man, I signed Bam 640 before, too.
You
man.
Did.
Yeah, he did. And I was about to get to that. He made me a better artist. He started the different my movement. Man, Jag was on his bro. And the people that me, Fresh Money, all of us, they still doing their things together. And Jag was the first one to put me in a professional post shoot. I was like, oh shit. I'm doing shit. You know what I'm saying? And he did shows and he did the things and he do things for the city. And people do things. And what are we doing? What so many DMBs are doing with the crying, the complaining, the bullshit, the not promoting. They won't promote themselves, but they'll promote a main industry artist on there. They'll promote memes. They'll promote what's busted. But they won't promote that they on the show next week. You know what I'm saying? So many people like Eddie Kayne and B-Zell, along with Jag, Bishop Twan, have opened the doors for us. Like, shout out my man Uptown Slim. When I first wanted to rap, I said, okay, I'm doing Go-Go. But Go-Go is already hot. Go-Go don't need Bam 640. They already good. They got Backyard, Big G, Bugs. Go-Go is doing good right now. Even what Big G would have. But see, what Eddie Kayne was doing, he would give you an interview and performing. Interview and perform for $10. The nigga still had a problem with that.
Man, you know, I count it all a blessing. That's my motto.
Yeah, but I'm just saying.
Because at the end of the day, you got guys that came out of the showcase and went on to be great. Beano.
Right.
Flex Cartel. A lot of them dudes came out of the showcase.
Right.
Facts. Came out of the showcases with us. So, you know, I salute to them brothers, man. There's a plenty of motherfuckers that came that's in the industry right now. Even Reek came through the Eddie Kayne show.
Right.
You
of
know?
Course, man.
And when, hey. I talked to my little bro, he told me, shit. What you tell me, little bro? That's where you, when you was coming up, that's all you used to hear about the Eddie Kayne show. When you was coming up, you know what I mean? So we provided a platform, but I'm humble.
But you're not even going to say the main platform you provided for them. It's a whole lot of rappers that was on that Howard D.A. stage that would not have been on there if it wasn't for Eddie Kayne.
Facts.
That wouldn't have been on there. They would not have been on there. They would not have been on there. And when I probably about my tip time on here back and forth, and he was just showing, hey, come up, do an interview and all that, and what he done so much, and it's so many people pioneers for the DMV that done so much for the DMV, and all they ask you to do is promote yourself, keep the music up, mix your stuff right, man. Shout out to Boone, the engineer, by the way, he mixed and mastered my whole CD. Good, great dude. Know what the hell he doing. Like, sometimes you have to invest in yourself. If you don't want to invest in yourself, you might as well start a savings fund or something. Go run, whatever you want to do. Because everything costs. Everything costs.
I remember a time, and I'm going to fuss at you because you're a lady. Shout out to your wife because she ride with you everywhere, man. Y'all be like the damn, y'all couple be arguing like shit. I be seeing y'all on Instagram.
To be honest, though, the secret to making money is not saving. You have to spend money to make money.
Yeah. And that's the realest shit ever.
I'm just saying, if you don't have the money to put out there, you got to save me till you get it. You know what I'm saying?
A lot of cats don't believe in that model. I mean, we come from, the newer cats come from what's called finesse. Everybody's about finessing. I'm going to finesse them. I remember when we started at finesse. I remember Do Baby started that shit. Finesse. And then from everything that ever dripped down, these youngins wanted to finesse everything. And some people, man, it's not when you're doing business, it ain't about finessing. You know what I mean? And a lot of cats don't understand. They get the two mixed up. Hey, but Bam, what else you got going on, man? Where can we find you at?
Man, Bam640_GSE, man, Goon Squad. Y'all already know what to do. That's on Instagram. Bam Moore's on Facebook. Bam640 fan page, man. We moving, man. We like book up to October right now. We going back out Miami at the Reggae Festival. I'm performing out Miami. So
damn.
I mean, that's real, real big. I got a couple of host joints I'm doing with Junkyard and Backyard and everything, and I'm going back out Atlanta in the next 2 weeks to promote the album. I'm live at Toppin's, man. It's a good thing.
Yeah, Top is pizza, man. Yeah. I've been in that motherfucker before. Yeah,
hey, that's my man. Hey, look, and then we got the Super Bowl party with Bam 6-4 in Backyard out top is out of Atlanta. Coming back in February.
You know, that's my second home, man. They know me real good.
I love them. Hey, look, man. They
show you much love out real there. Good.
And I'm going to tell you a story about Atlanta. You know, the Never Gonna Stop with me and Janae. We submitted to everybody, all the FM radio. They would not play it. We went to Atlanta. You know that joint been the number one internet radio song. It was on internet radio song for like 4 weeks in a row, and it has not dropped under five. So it was so great that the dude from Atlanta wanted to get on the remix.
On the remix, up.
Yeah. I mean, it's real. I mean, they respect different, but it's real music. And I'm
going to say this. The times have changed in the DMV.
Yeah.
So the music scene is much different. It ain't right. Like it used to be.
Right.
So just give it an opportunity, because I'm telling you, if you notice, we got like 20, we got a Michael Jordan in the game right now.
Yeah.
23 artists legitimately making noise in the game.
Right.
Just give it some more time. I didn't lead a scene. I just took time out to stop doing shows to focus on other bigger things. But we ain't gonna hold you. Shout out to you. We get ready to get you to the stage. You just dropped your new project, Forever Legendary.
I want to shout out. I was talking to my man Mike Angelo, man, that lost his niece. And that's two DMV artists' niece. On the father's side, Ferragamo Damo, who's on the album, that's his niece. And Mike Angelo. I will be at Pure tomorrow for that benefit concert with him, Fed Trail, and so much.
What time is that?
Per Lounge, 7 to 11 tomorrow.
Yeah, we're going to slide over after we leave. You know, we got 1,000 black men with love.
Yeah.
Going to be over Clay Terrace. We're going to give all the kids food.
We can do that too.
Yeah. We're going to get the kids food, and we're going to get the kids ice cream, man, because, you know, Micaiah died.
Yeah.
And this is no benefit. This is not raising money for her. We are not accepting any money on her behalf. But this is just to give the kids in the community something, because you never understand what a child will remember. And that's if you're another child and you was out there and you saw that, that will be something you will never forget. So what we want to do for one day, and I found out too, so many kids are hungry and not eating on the weekends.
Right.
Saturday and Sunday, they starve. So that's why they can't wait to get back to school on Monday to eat.
Hey, that's crazy. Yeah. And shout out to my people's out Baltimore. This 7-year-old girl got killed. My son only 8. So I be feeling all that. 7 years old, 10 years old. These kids ain't get ready to live.
Shout out to you too. I know you just lost your cousin. Much respect and condolences to the family.
It's crazy out here.
And I just pray for all of y'all. Hey, we ain't gonna keep on talking.
What?
You came here to do something.
Let's do it, man.
All right.
I'm ready.
My man Bam 640, not a stranger to the Eddie Kayne Show. Yeah. Get right, hit the stage. Which one we going with? Forever Legendary first?
We're going way out, because Forever Legendary, that's featuring my man Sha Guapo. And people always say, dang, you do all these features. But I love for all of us DMB to be all on it. Me, Bills, Guapo, and Cousin Pop off on that Forever Legendary. You know?
Hey,
but the way out is more, that's like me. That's all me right there.
All right, let's get into it right now. Only on the Eddie Kayne Show, my man Bam 640. Hey, after this, right directly after this, we going straight into the top indie video countdown, sponsored by Cloud9 Vodka. Hey, DMV Hood News.
Here.
I hope you stay around, man, or we want to talk for a minute, man, and I hope that you come to the family, man, because you definitely deserve it. You already an icon in your own light, man.
Appreciate it, man. Appreciate it.
All right, let's get into it. Bam 640. This joint here called Way Out, right?
This some real shit right here, though. I ain't lying. Shout out to my man, Marga L.A. on the hook, man.
Marga doing fucking nuts.
If you know me, you know I'm on my way.
Live, man. They party after this, though.
It won't last.
Jay, my nigga. This some real, man. We bringing real music back, man. Yeah, shout out to my man Eddie Kayne, man. The mentor. Since the age of 13, been trapping on the streets. Son of a hustler trying to stay on my feet. Moving in silence, that's the code of the streets. What choice do I have? Me and the fam gotta eat. Wasn't happy here, but I was forced to lead the way. On the corner serving dope just for a place to stay. The journey gets greater, know I'm on my way. Grinding so hard to my death day. Real niggas run the way out. Stacking in the trap house. Hustlers staying alive. That's what I'm about. Lord, forgive me, for I have sinned. In reality, all I do is want to win. This probably be the realest shit I ever spoke.
I've been on my path, taking my chance, but it won't last.
Yeah.
Oh, my mama, I need a way out.
Let's get it.
An escape from myself, from my ghost. I've been looking for a way out, a way out, a way out. Looking for a way out, a way out, a way out.
Hey. No new friends, turn into no friends. Hit rock bottom solo at the end. King of the city, look what I become. Stressed out so much, drinking straight rum. No loyalty in the game of life. Even through the struggle, I kept my grind tight. Only God can judge me, we gon' be alright. 45 on my side, even through the night. Survivor of the fittest, rest in peace, prodigy. Real hip hop lives through me. Win, lose, draw, forever 640. Look at me now, I'm forever legendary. I be getting deep with this joke, man, for real.
I've been on my path, taking my chance. It won't last.
Forever legendary on Spinrilla right now, by the way.
An escape from myself, from my ghost.
Last verse, and I'm out of here. Listen. Pooty gone, easy ain't coming back. Live through me, this my bounce back. Pain and blessings, blessings and pain. Gotta salute me like a young Major Payne. Came a long way, but I got more to gain. Niggas talking reckless, middle fingers to the lane. Before it's said and done, the world gon' know my name. Another man's success is another man's stress. Even Ray Charles can see I'm the best. It's the rumble in the jungle, gotta stay humble. Last man standing like I won a Royal Rumble. Stack the chips up, I bet they all crumble. Shout out to my man Eddie Kayne, that's real shit. If y'all don't feel that, I don't know what you gon' feel. Yeah.
Oh, my mama, I need a way out.
That's dedicated to my mother, by the way, man.
Tell the people where they can find you at, Bam.
Bam 640 GSE. Shit, Instagram. Bam Boys on Facebook. Bam 640 fan page, man. Forever legendary in stores right now, man. We sold 100 CDs the first night, man.
Man, you going to rock this first verse. Let's get into it. Get your ass first on that stage.
Yeah, you want? It's featuring my man, Sean Guapo. Bills, cousin pop off, man. Let me rock this first verse. Let's get it.
I'm forever a legend, nigga. That's if I die or if I live. Boy, my city know exactly what I did.
Yeah.
I'm forever a legend. All them late nights on the block, holding
rocks, hoping 12 don't kick the spot.
Boy, I'm forever a legend. And I don't do it for the gram, it's for the fam. Trying to feed me and my mans.
Let's get it. Fuck you think I do it for? Early morning, late nights, trapping out the corner store. Naughty boy lifestyle, still pull a kick though. 640 to the casket drop, to build a switch up. Bam 640, I ain't gotta touch you for you to get fucked up. Forever DC legend, paranoid, sleeping with my weapon. Shit gets real in a matter of seconds. Rest in peace, Dread. Prices on my head. I know it's some fuck niggas that wanna see me dead. God's plans, though, I ain't never scared. Hold to the streets, trying to stay on my feet. Niggas talking reckless, like shit sweet. Before I'm dead and gone, my city gon' remember me. Forever legendary, gave you all I had in me. Moving in silence, yeah, I know the feds listening between me and you. Got my bitch whipping in the kitchen. Shout out to my man Eddie Kayne, man.
Hey, yo, bring it over here. Bring it over here, man. WLVS Radio, man. Before we get out of here, y'all gotta shout out some people, man. That's my man, Bam 640, man. Much love to him, man. That's called legendary. Right here on the Eddie Kayne Show, that's your
team. Shout out DMV Hoods and News for coming through today, man.
Hold up, hold up, hold up. We gotta let y'all shout yourselves out before we get out of here, man.
Yeah, Black Queen in the city, Patrice Perry. Thank y'all for tuning in.
I go by Remix Reek. Make sure y'all follow the kid on Instagram, Remix R-E-E-K, and download my new mixtape.
Hold up, you can see right there. He's gonna bring you in. Yeah, he's gonna bring you right in.
Who is Remix?
All right, we got a show, hopefully, new hood correspondent once a month. Talk to the people, man. I want you to break, make him bigger. Make
man,
him bigger.
Everybody,
make him bigger.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe to DMV Hoods and News, man. Don't forget to also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DMV Hoods and News, man. I got a breaking news, man, because everybody keep talking about, man, why you still got an Android, man. The iPhone is coming soon, man. I got the iPhone coming soon. A lot of people don't know, man, since I started DMV Hoods News, man, 95% of my stories come from this phone right here, man.
Yeah, I'm team Android, too. You can talk about me like a dog.
You know what I'm saying? Hey. But the iPhone, I got to get the iPhone for the business.
Make sure you come join team iPhone.
Hey, man, tell them one more time where they can find y'all at. We can get out of here.
Man, make sure you follow the kid at Remix Reek, man. Hit me in my DM and let me know that you follow me off the show. I'm showing love, man.
All right.
Again, Patrice Perry. That's Patrice.Perry, P-A-R-I underscore on IG.
Hey. Your name?
Oh, yeah, man. DMV Hoods and News, at DMV Hoods and News. Twitter and Instagram. Also, man, subscribe to me on YouTube at DMV Hoods and News. It's easy. Just put, once you put DMV and you put Hoods, you're going to find me.
We out of here, man. We going to the top videos. This is the squad. Eddie Kayne Show every Saturday, 1 to 4 p.m. Eastern. Right here. Let's get into